Coach, 10-0. We're at the Coliseum this afternoon. What surprised you so far about this season? This is a heck of a place to be right now.
Well, it's a great place to be. We were hoping we could get to this situation and come in here 10-0, but I didn't know if we could or not. You just try to play each game and approach it as best you can. I think the thing that's probably surprised me the most would be two things. Number one would be the fact that our seniors have accepted their role and really set the example for the rest of the football team. The other thing that I think is rather amazing, Larry, is through 10 football games, the University of Notre Dame football team has been ready to play in 9 of them. Only one time did I feel that we were rather flat or didn't have a strong desire to play the game or play together as a team the way we think we ought to. So I think those two things have surprised me. I thought maybe we'd play a little bit better technique-wise, but I didn't know we'd play as well as a team. We certainly hoped and had visions of being a good football team, even though we're young and inexperienced in many respects, but that's over. We're not freshmen and sophomores anymore. I mean, they've been through a season. They know what it's all about, and we're playing a great football team, and when you play a great football team, you better be at your best, and hopefully that's what we'll be today.
Coach, it's been a great year. Love doing the show with you again this year. It's been a fantastically exciting year, but this afternoon, what do you have to do to beat the Trojans?
I think that, number one, we cannot let them dominate the line of scrimmage with either their offense or the defense, such as they have done in the past. They have really dominated the line of scrimmage, and Rodney Pete has made an awful lot of big plays. But I think if we don't let them dominate the line of scrimmage, and if we don't turn the football over, if we don't have a fumble or an interception, and we play well up front, I think we have a very good chance to win this football game. But those two things are going to be critical.
Coach, thanks for the exciting year.
Well, thanks for Mutual for having us, and it's our privilege to be associated with you, Larry.
Hope we get that victory, Coach.
Amen.
All righty, now back to Tony Roberts in the booth.
Hi again, everybody. I'm Tony Roberts along with Tom Pagnett. Jam-packed Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum on a bright sunny day. Notre Dame and Southern Cal. Only 8 points separate these two teams in the AP college football rankings this past week. Last Notre Dame team to come to California unbeaten, the 1970 squad 9-0, lost the regular season finale 38-28 to Southern Cal, despite Joe Theismann's school record 526 passing yards. Meanwhile, Southern Cal has the longest regular season winning streak of major college football. Michigan State defeated USC 2017 in the Rose Bowl, but last regular season setback was administered by Notre Dame 26-17 in South Bend in 87. Since that time, the Trojans have won 14 regular season games in a row.
Tony, the Trojans have such great tradition. This marks 100 years of what they're calling and terming athletic excellence, and certainly it's a good term because it has been 100 years of great football players and tradition.
More in a moment. This is Notre Dame Football on Mutual.
Your team Pontiac dealer says get on a Pontiac and ride one of the hottest road cars going, the 89 Pontiac Grand Am, a true driver's car with road-hugging suspension, power rack and pinion steering, and a newly designed, sleeker, hotter look. Grand Ams come with the available power of the 16-valve quad 4 engine. Come test ride the Pontiac Grand Am, which comes with GM's 3-year or 50,000-mile bumper-to-bumper plus warranty. There's a $100 deductible per repair visit after the first 12 months or 12,000 miles. See your dealer for terms of this limited warranty. And now for a limited time, you can get a $500 factory rebate on any 89 Grand Am at your New York, New Jersey, Connecticut Team Pontiac dealer. You must take retail delivery from dealer stock by 1-389. See dealer for details.
See your local New York, New Jersey, Connecticut Team Pontiac dealer for a rebate program.
Now, Tidy Cat 3 is a hard-working cat box filler.
Tidy Cat 3, when you go, it deodorizes better, a dog like a real go-getter, leaves no dust or tracks around, Tidy Cat 3.
I'm Ed Lowe. My Tidy Cat 3 is 99% dust-free, so it's cleaner and healthier for your cat. And with my Tidy Cat 3 cat box liners, you may never have to wash your cat box again.
The starting lineup for the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. At wide receiver, it'll be number 25, the freshman, Ragit Ismail. The other wide receiver, in all probability, is going to be Pat Otter, since Ricky Waters was sent home. Meanwhile, at the offensive tackles, it'll be Andy Heck and Dean Brown. Winston Sandry and Tim Grunhardt are the guards. Mike Held at center. Frank Jacobs or Derek Brown. Derek Brown will probably start at tight end, although Frank Jacobs started last week because Brown was in the hospital. Tony Rice is going to be the quarterback. Braxton Banks will be the fullback. And, of course, the tailback is going to be Mark Green. Now for the Trojans of Southern California. At wide receiver, he's already made one All-America team, Eric Affolder, a senior from Agoura, California. The other flanker, John Jackson. The tight end is going to be Scott Galbraith. At the tackles, it'll be John Guerrero and Derek Marshall. Brent Parkinson and Mark Tucker are the guards. Brad Leggett is the center. And the Heisman Trophy candidate, Rodney Peete, of course, the quarterback. Leroy Holt will play most of the game at fullback. And Scott Lockwood, considered to be one of the best players ever to come out of the state of Colorado, will be the starting tailback. So there you have the starting lineup. The kickoff's coming up right after this timeout for Progresso.
Warm up before or after the game with delicious Progresso soups. A welcome idea for all tailgate and post-game parties. Just bring a big container of Progresso vegetable soup. It's brimming with 10 select vegetables and sunny Italian flavor. With a taste so wholesomely satisfying, Progresso will become your tailgate party tradition. So when you're getting ready for the big game, everyone will agree. There's no soup like Progresso.
Hi, folks. Hey, this is your old weather friend Willard Scott for True Value Hardware, your store of first choice. This year, Santa is loaded down with a variety of electronic gifts, like the handy Casio 8-digit solar calculator for just $2.99 and the Casio solar wallet calculator for only $8.88 that features extra-large keys. Then, enjoy portable music with the Sanyo AM-FM cassette player recorder. It's only $39.99 at participating True Value Hardware stores and home centers.
Tidy Cat 3 is a hard-working cat box filler.
Tidy Cat 3, when you go, it deodorizes better, so it's like a real go-getter, leaves no dust, no tracks around, Tidy Cat 3.
I'm Ed Lowe. My Tidy Cat 3 is 99% dust-free, so it's cleaner and healthier for your cat. With my Tidy Cat 3 cat box liners, you may never have to wash your cat box again.
Here's why experienced drivers feel so much better with State Farm. When you're into your 50s or 60s, you've been driving long enough, been in enough tough spots, you know just what you want from a car insurance company. You want an agent who's there to give you plenty of personal service. When you run into trouble, you want claims people who handle things fast and fair. You want a sense of security. That's why you came to State Farm. That's why you're going to stay.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is gone.
At the moment, the 20 seniors who are graduating from Southern Cal are being announced and coming out under the goalposts off to our left. Southern Cal, the first team to win 8 Pac-10 games ever in a season. The first to go unbeaten in Pac-10 play since 1979 when the Trojans did it, 6-0 that year. Tom Pagna, I have never been at Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum for a football game when it has been as crowded, as packed as it is today. Tickets, of course, are at a premium. Traffic outside is horrendous. We're fortunate to be here. It is a great day for football, and it could be, well, this is certainly Notre Dame's biggest game of the 1980s, and it may be the biggest game since you fellas won a couple of championships there in 73 and 77, and it could rank with the one in 1966 against Michigan State.
I think it definitely does, Tony. It's so rare for two great football teams to come down to the last game of the year, the regular schedule, and be undefeated. Two great teams like Notre Dame, of course, and Southern California. I've never been at a bigger one as a spectator anyhow.
Tom, you have coached here at Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum against Southern Cal. And the Trojans, of course, are difficult to beat here, as the Irish are in South Bend.
Absolutely. I don't know what it is about a home field advantage. I've never taken any stock in that. If it's a 100-yard field, I figure you got an even chance. However, there's something about coming to the West Coast for us, Notre Dame, and something about Southern Cal coming to South Bend that changes the whole personality and perspective of the game. I know one thing, it'll be a very competitively fought football game right down to the last moment.
Tom, a lot has been made early in the week about the fact that Lou Holtz called Jimmy Johnson, the coach at Miami of Florida, and asked him about his success on the road. And Miami of Florida has been one of the most successful teams on the road. And Jimmy Johnson's formula was very simple. Don't let the crowd intimidate you.
Well, I think Jimmy Johnson can say that because he's a passing coach. Whenever you want to push the crowd, all you need is a chunk of yardage. The passing game does that for you.
The last time Notre Dame played here, 1986, the game was the turning point that turned Notre Dame, returned Notre Dame, that is, to respectability. The Irish wiped out a 17-point deficit in the last 12 minutes and went on to defeat Southern Cal 38-37. John Carney's 19-yard field goal, as time ran out, completed the Irish comeback. Jim Brown set up that winning field goal with a spectacular 56-yard punt return. It was only the second punt return of his career. At that time, of course, Jim Brown was a junior.
Tim Brown that day was electrifying, no question. And I remember you and I doing the broadcast. One of the things we'd have to say, looking back in retrospect, is that was a turning point for Lou Holtz's coach football teams at Notre Dame. Because from that point forward, the Irish took on a confidence that they haven't relinquished to this day.
The Trojans have been announced. They're on the field. The Irish are on the field. Talking about the Trojans across the way, Southern Cal, as we spoke a moment ago, difficult to beat here. They have won 10 straight in Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum the past two seasons under their head coach, Larry Smith. Notre Dame was the last team to beat the Trojans here. That was the final game of the 86 season. As we told you, the Irish rallied from 17 down to win 38-37. So a lot of streaks on the line. Larry Smith, the coach at Southern Cal, has said, hey, this is for the national championship. Lou Holtz says, not quite, not when you have one more game to play.
Well, that's true. I said to him in the hallway the other day on back in the Notre Dame campus, congratulations, Lou. And he said, Tom, we haven't done anything yet. I said, boy, you can't choose to ignore those 10 wins that you took on before meeting Southern Cal. He said, no, but our goal is to become the national champion.
Notre Dame has won the toss, and they have deferred.
That might be smart on a day like today. There are a lot of emotion out there today, and I think emotion will play a part in the breaks because it'll be a game of breaks. That's probably the only thing that separates these two great football teams.
And Southern Cal is going to receive their 31-22 victory over last Saturday, over UCLA last Saturday. We'll send, of course, the Trojans to the Rose Bowl for an unprecedented 26th time. And in 25 previous trips to Pasadena, down the road a piece, Southern Cal has prevailed 18. They have lost 7.
Tony, Southern Cal had to beat on their way here Oklahoma, of course, and UCLA, two great football teams. By the same token, Notre Dame had Michigan and Miami, two great football teams. So the road here in 10-0 was not an easy one, and today, of course, is a real matchup.
Notre Dame leads the series, 32 wins, 23 losses, 4 ties. Irish have won the last 5 meetings. First time in 60 matchups that both teams are undefeated. USC 5-1-2 versus Notre Dame when unbeaten. The Irish are 6-4-1 against Southern Cal when they have been undefeated.
I'll be anxious to see as the Trojans line up for the kickoff if Rodney Peete will be barking the signals. As you know, 2 weeks ago he had measles, then he got a little case of laryngitis. They worked over how they would call the cadence with another back.
Calvin Holmes is the deep man down the middle. On the near side, you'll have Scott Lockwood, considered to be one of the best players ever to come out of the state of Colorado. And we'll check the far side for you. And that would be Ricky Irvin, a two-year man from Pasadena, California, sophomore. So the Irish are set to kick. Now, one of the oddities of this game, talking to Tim Tessalone, the sports information director for Southern Cal, he said, we don't have a strong kicking game. We have a hard time getting the ball on the kickoff down to the 10-yard line. I said, join the group. Maybe everybody's going to have field position today.
It's a very even game, then.
So the ball is teed up. And this one, the biggest one of the season, about to get underway. Jam-packed Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum, the run-up and the kick. It comes down high. It's also going to come down very short. It's going to be taken by one of the upbacks, brought back to the 25-yard line, and that's as far as it will go. So it'll be first down and 10 with a ball at the 26-yard line. And it was Tracy Butts. He's a graduating senior. He was one of the 20 players who was announced that will graduate, and he will be missing, of course, from Southern Cal next year. Michael Small, he's a freshman out of Rialto, California. He's going to have an outstanding career at Notre Dame. On the special teams, made the stop, so it'll be first down and 10 for Southern Cal at their own 26. Now for a look at a viable Heisman Trophy candidate, and of course, we're talking about Rodney Peete. Peete got him, split. Slot right, wide out left, going to throw, back the pass, near side, pass is caught, catch made, and it's Gary Wellman who makes the grab, and he's finally stopped up around the, maybe about the 33-yard line. Wes Pritchett made the tackle on the play after a gain of almost 8 yards. It'll be second down and about three. Coming to the game in the parking lot, I ran into Wes Pritchett's mom. What a beautiful, beautiful lady, and she is so proud of her son.
Well, he backed up Todd Light there. Todd Light missed the tackle on the corner, trying to come up and shut it off for a short gain. Wes Pritchett covered the air.
Second down and 4 after a gain of 6. I tandem. Holt is the fullback. Here's the handoff going to Aaron Emanuel, and he fights his way up past the 35 to the 38-yard line before getting stopped. Now, Aaron Emanuel kind of embodies all the qualities of all the backs, Scott Lockwood, Ricky Irvin, and Calvin Holmes. He's got a little bit of each of their qualities, and he's outstanding. A junior out of Palmdale, California, had a big game against UCLA last week.
And he's been coming on strong towards the end of this season, very much so, Tony, and I think probably today he and Scott Lockwood will carry the burden.
Wellman flank to the left, Affolder out to the right, first and 10, Southern Cal at the 39-yard line. I tandem. Give to the fullback, Leroy Hull, comes off the left side, fights his way up to about the 45-yard line. Todd Light and company come up over there to make the stop along with Frank Sams. So it'll be a gain on the play of another 6.5 yards. It'll be second down at about 3.5 to go for a first down.
We're not seeing anything fancy by Southern Cal. They've got a big line, their left tackle at 320, their right tackle at 305. They line up with maximum splits. They block you one-on-one. Their eye back and fullback, when they're in a tandem, just read the daylight. Now they're divided, usually they're passing formation.
Second down at about 3.5 to go. Deuce back to your slot is to the left. Rodney Peete back to throw, gets hit, it fires a pass. The pass is caught, the catch is made, it will not be enough for a first down. Michael Stonebreaker laid it on Rodney Peete. Affolder made the catch just as Rodney Peete was being hit. His arm went forward. Affolder made the catch. Stonebreaker on the blitz makes the hit, but just wasn't able to pull Rodney Peete down.
I saw Rodney Peete play against Arizona State a couple weeks ago. I walked away very impressed. He's got an awful lot of poise. He can throw the ball with anybody I've ever seen, but he's very mobile.
Third down, 0.5 yard to go. Seven Cal will go double tight end with a flanker right. It's Jackson. Rodney Peete turns around. Hands the ball to Holt. Holt to the 50. Holt to the 45. Holt to the 40-yard line before he finally stops. Nice run by Leroy Holt, and Holt finally stopped by Stan Smigala. So it'll be a first down for Southern Cal at the Irish 40-yard line.
Irish lined up in a blitz formation, brought the safeties, the inside safeties, right up to the line of scrimmage almost. We're going to go with a full blitz, put them in man-to-man coverage, and anything that breaks the surface of that puts you in the clear field, which is exactly what happened to Southern Cal.
Pat Terrell had the first shot at Leroy Hope, but could not bring him down. First and 10, Southern Cal at the Irish 40-yard line. Jackson out to the left. Here's Peete back to throw, looking, throwing long down the right side. Affolder behind Todd Light, breaks it up at the last second out at the 3-yard line. Great recovery by Todd Light when it looked like Rodney Peete could get six on a long pass down to Eric Affolder inside the Irish 5.
Affolder is probably one of the most outstanding receivers in college football. Todd Light, for a moment, had his back turned to it, made a great recovery, great athletic ability. Focused on the ball and made a great defensive play to stop a touchdown.
2 of 3 for Rodney Peete, 8 yards. It'll be second down and 10, Southern Cal. Ball up the Irish 40, hash mark far side. Affolder is wide to the right. In motion to the near side is Gary Wellman. Here's the handoff to the tailback, Emanuel. Down to the 35, and he fights his way down to about the 32-yard line. Wes Pritchett is there to make the tackle on the play along with linebacker Frank Sams. So it'll be a gain on the play of almost 6 yards or so. Second down, make it 7 yards. Second down and about three.
Well, forgive the comparison, Tony, but this takes me back to some of the John McKay offensive machinations that they used to do with a great tailback series or the fake to the tailback, which freezes everybody in the arm of Rodney Peete.
34 yards on four rushes for Southern Cal. Deuce backfield, slot right or wide out to the left. Notre Dame with three down linemen and flank stands coming on the rush on the near side. Long pass downfield, incomplete, down at the five-yard line. It's centered for Gary Wellman, the sophomore from Westlake Village. Tried to make the diving grab, and going with him down that right side was Todd Light. So now it is going to be a situation where the Trojans have the football, and they also have a situation where it is fourth down at about 3 yards to go. Chris Spurl, he's a senior out of Fountain Valley, California, averaging almost 39 yards a punt, very much like his counterpart on Notre Dame, Jim Sexton.
Instead of punting, Spurl likes to arch the ball and get it really high for them to get down under it.
Here's the high spiral punt. It'll come down somewhere down around the goal line. It is caught by one of the Trojans down at the two-yard line, and the Irish are going to be in a hole. It was Mark Carter who made the catch. It'll be Notre Dame's ball, first and 10 at the two. Timeout, no score. Now this for Hostess.
Gee, 3 a.m. I want a Twinkie. So dark. Aha, I found you. Mm-hmm. Boy, there's strawberry in my Twinkie. Discover new fruit and cream Twinkies with real strawberries swirled inside its creamy middle. Original Twinkies, too. Gee, can't a man eat in peace? My brother Tommy used to have remote controls all over the place.
Yeah, they were everywhere. They were all over the place.
A TV remote, a cable remote, a VCR remote.
I was pretty confused. I didn't know what
you were out of control, Tom.
Yeah.
But then Tommy bought a Magnavox TV with an amazing remote.
And Magnavox invented it.
It's three remotes in one. It controls the Magnavox TV it came with, plus just about any brand of wireless cable and VCR. So my brother Tom's not confused anymore.
Yeah. And neither am I.
Magnavox. Smart choice. Very smart.
The ball at the two-yard line. It'll be first down and 10 for the Irish. And as we put the glasses on the Notre Dame team, we find that Eilers is starting as the wideout in the place of Ricky Waters, and Anthony Johnson is starting at fullback.
Tony, Lou Holtz is more apt to put the ball in the air deep from his own end zone than he is at midfield. That's just the way he thinks, but they have to run it out of there if they're going to have real success.
Eilers flank to the left, Ismail wide to the right. Johnson the fullback, Mark Green the tailback. Hand off to Green, not going to get very low. It was a quick and here, pass downfield to Ismail at the 50. He's down to the 45, he stumbled. He's down to the 40-yard line. What a tremendous fake by Mark Green and by Tony Wright. And the Irish went for the long bomb down to the 43-yard line of Southern Cal. But the fake made the play.
Absolutely. When he made that tailback fake and they went into the line, everybody, including, I think, the fans, saw that it was a run, except for the quarterback and Ismail. Good for a hookup of 56 yards. Got him out of the hole.
And Notre Dame has the ball on a 56-yard bomb from Wright to Ismail at the 43-yard line of Southern Cal, first and 10. High tandem again. Toss to Green off the left side, and Green's going to find it going a little rough. Not going to be able to go anywhere. Green not able to get outside. Cordell Sweeney, a junior out of San Jose, California, coming up to make the stop on the play. So it'll be second down, a loss on the play, back to the 46-yard line. Second down at about 14 yards to go for the first down.
The Southern Cal defensive units' team speed overall will almost match Notre Dame's, I believe. Laterally, they really move. They've held most opponents to 80 yards or less on the ground.
Sweeney is taking the wide side of the field. Second down and long, almost 15. Wright looking, swings it out to Green to the 50, down to the 45, and he's down to about the 42-yard line. Right back to the original line of scrimmage and maybe a couple of yards more. So whatever they lost, he got that and a couple of yards more. They'll mark it closer to the 41-yard line, and it's going to be third down now at about 9 for the Irish at the Southern Cal 41. And if the Irish can't run, they may be in for a long, long afternoon. Tony Rice came in with a 50% completion percentage. A touchdown, 7 intercepts. Lot left, high tandem, dropping back, blitz is on, fires over the middle. He's got the tight end, Derek Brown, and the freshman makes the grab, but it's not going to be enough for the first down. He is nailed in his tracks immediately down around the 37-yard line, which will leave Notre Dame with about fourth down and about 5 yards to go for a first down.
It'd be about a 54-yard field goal attempt if they did it, and I don't think they'd even gamble it. They'll punt it and try to return the favor, gain the real estate down to the short side of the field.
Now it is up to Jim Sexton, the sophomore out of South Bend, Indiana. But the Irish got most of it in one lump sum, 56 yards.
What a gutsy call. Great place for it.
It appears that Scott Lockwood down around the 10-yard line for Southern California. Jim Sexton standing at the midfield stripe. We have no score. We have a penalty marker.
Delay a game against the Irish.
Well, they don't have to take it. That's right. They can decline it. So Southern Cal declined the penalty. And Sexton, again at the 50-yard line, set the punt. No score. Each team has had the ball one time. Here come the Trojans on the rush and the punt. High coming down, it'll bounce inside the 10, bounces at the 5-yard line, it's touched out there, and it's down at about the 4-yard line. So it'll be Southern Cal's ball at that spot. This is Notre Dame football on Mutual.
Hi, Mr. Keebler.
Your cheerleaders.
Cheer, cheer for all.
You don't sound cheery.
It's our tortilla chips.
They're a little heavy.
Try our light and crispy Sancheros.
Sancheros?
Tortilla chips made by Pequeños Quibleros, elfin cousins from the southwestern branch of the tree.
Let's hear it for Sancheros.
Sancheros, Sancheros. Light and crispy because they're made by Pequeños Quibleros. Yay!
I fear for the opposition.
W. No score after a 32-yard punt. Southern Cal with the ball at the 4. A look at the Sears scoreboard. Georgia Tech trailing Georgia 24-3 in the fourth quarter. 3-3 Mississippi State in the second. Tennessee trailing Vanderbilt by 1.5, 7-6. Houston 21, Rice 14 in the third. Arkansas was beaten by Miami of Florida 18-16. That is a final. Tulsa 22, Colorado State nothing in the first. And it was Temple 45, Boston College 28. That is a final score. That's the Sears scoreboard. Sears, where you get your money's worth and a whole lot more.
Tony, we just saw a great change of field position from one to the other. Southern Cal made a sustained drive, got down, then punted it inside the Irish 2. The Irish come out with that long 56-yard gainer, tried to fight for a first down, and then traded field position, and now Southern Cal's taking it over on their own 3.
And let's see if Rodney Pete goes the same route that Lou Holtz did with quarterback Tony Roy. Southern Cal is 14th in passing offense. They've been averaging about 249 yards a game. Rodney Pete has completed 63% of his passes for 2,429 yards, 18 touchdowns, 8 intercepts.
But one of the things he does best is roll out with the football, and I think we might see something like that down here, which gives him the option to run it a little safer, less risky.
Double tight end, flanker to the right. Rodney Pete rolling to the right, looking to throw. Fires the ball over the middle. The pass is caught. Tight end Galbraith has got it, and he gets nailed over the 15-yard line. A pickup of 11 on the play, and a first down.
And I think the Irish are going to have to defend that all day. When you got the wide side of the field, you got two receivers. Rodney Pete rolling into it is dangerous.
You saw Southern Cal play against Arizona State. They have more of a possession type passing game, do they not?
Yes, it's just very rare that they'll go for a bomb. They hit a bomb with Wellman, Gary Wellman, a backup reserve who's got 4-3 speed, but that's not their style.
First down and 10, the ball at the 15-yard line. High tandem, Wellman in motion from flanker right to the far side. Hand off to Holt, the fullback, and the fullback gets up to about the 19-yard line. It'll be a gain of around 4 on the play. Tackle made by several Irish defenders. Brian Flannery coming in to make part of the stop on the play. Flannery, a junior out of Lakewood, Ohio. A gain of 4, it'll be second down and 6. Now, Rodney Pete, of course, hospitalized with the measles. last week. He had one light one-hour workout. That was on last Friday. It came back on Saturday. Hit 16 out of 28, a touchdown, 189 yards, and he also ran for a score. Not a bad afternoon for a guy who didn't practice at all. Aaron Emanuel leaps over one man at the 20 and gets nailed at about the 25-yard line by George Streeter, the strong safety for the Irish, and it is very close to a Southern Cal first down.
George Streeter's impact from that tackle knocked Aaron Emanuel laterally, which probably, if anything, saved him making the first down. Aaron Emanuel, incidentally, is about 6'2", 215 pounds, no small lad.
Aaron Emanuel, he came off the bench to rush for 113 yards and two touchdowns last week against Southern Cal, rather against the UCLA. Lockwood is now in a tailback. Holt still remains the fullback. Hand off to Lockwood, and Lockwood hit by Wes Pritchett. Wes Pritchett knifing in, made a diving grab and dropped Lockwood for about a loss of a yard, maybe as many as two. Not around the 24, 25. They're going to mark it at the 25. It'll be a loss of a half yard. Loss of a half yard.
Wes Pritchett came right over the offensive right guard. He fired the gap and actually caught running out of the eye. You can do that. It takes so long to get to the line of scrimmage.
They have third down and short, and with fourth down coming up, Southern Cal is going to punt, and it's going to be Irish back there to return punt for the Irish. So the dangerous one, Ricky Waters, on a flight back to South Bend, Indiana this morning, and Pat Irish will take over the punt return duties. He is standing at the Notre Dame 33. Sproul gets the snap and gets the punt off the 15. Very, very high spiral. Eiler signals fair catch and makes it down around the 28-yard line. And Notre Dame's got the ball first down and 10 after a 48-yard punt. No score, timeout. Now this for Avis.
When you want to make a dream come true, you wonder what you've got to do to win a car, see sports history, get money to go on a shopping spree. All you have to know is what it takes, and that is enter the Avis Great Seats Sweepstakes.
Avis is ready to put you in a great seat with the Avis Great Seats Sports Sweepstakes. Just fill out an entry at your participating Avis location between October 31st and December 10th, 1988. Grand prize is a luxurious Cadillac Alante sports car and a trip for two to your choice of any major sports event in the United States, plus $10,000 in cash. And there are other fabulous prizes, including a trip for two to Wimbledon on British Airways Concorde. No purchase necessary. Open to licensed drivers 21 years of age or older. Void where prohibited. Offer ends December 10th, 1988. See your participating Avis location for details. Avis, trying harder than the rest, even in sweepstakes.
Enter the Avis Great Seat Sweepstakes.
The Irish have the ball first down at 10. The ball is at the 28-yard line. Tony Rice comes into the game 65 out of 129, 50%, 1,085 yards passing, 8 touchdowns, 7 intercepts. His longest toss was a 67-yarder for a touchdown, and that was to the Rocket Ishmael, and he just nailed a 56-yarder in the very first play that Notre Dame had the ball when they were backed up to their 2-yard line. Now, Tony Rice is a winner. There's no doubt about that. He is 14-2 when starting at quarterback for Notre Dame.
Lou Holtz pointed that out the other day when somebody was a little bit critical of some of the things that have happened during the course season. He said, all he's done is win 14 out of 60. That's not a bad average.
They get some pretty decent competition. Ishmael wide to the right. Eiders flanked to the left. Green is the tailback. Tony Rice on the handoff to the fullback and dry knifing through is Anthony Johnson. Snakes his way up to about the 32-yard line. Again, it is Cordell Sweeney. Now, he's listed as the number three linebacker, but he's taking the wide side of the field for the most part. Cordell Sweeney, along with Delmar Chesley, a young man out of Washington, D.C., a junior, who have made the stop on the play. So the Irish get about three. It'll be second down and 7, and that Southern Cal defensive unit is really tough to run against. Slot to the left this time. Here's the handoff to the fullback, and again it is Anthony Johnson. And Anthony Johnson knifes the head up to about the 34-yard line. And he'll pick up a couple of more yards on the play, just about two. So Notre Dame not going to be looking at third down and about five. And while they do, we're going to pause briefly for station identification. This is Mutual, your network leader in radio sports.
You are listening to AM 1130 WNEW, New York.
Third down and just about three and a half yards to go for a first down for the Irish. Rice on the option, carrying for the first time to the 40, to the 45, down the sideline, at the 40, at the 30, at the 20. He could go all the way to 10 to 5. Touchdown, Irish! 65-yard run down the left side by Tony Rice, and he outlegged the entire Southern Cal defense.
We said it all year long, Tony, that Tony Rice is the fourth running back in the offensive backfield of the Irish. He stuck the ball in, rode the fullback, made a really nice fake and ride. The corner man and the safety man actually combined to bite the bait on the fake, which left a little daylight. That's all Tony Rice really needs, is a little daylight.
Replay, 72 yards, and Notre Dame has drawn first blood. Now the Irish are having some problems. They don't have enough people on the field. They've had problems with this a good part, at least the latter part of the campaign, and they may call a timeout here.
Well, again, Ricky Waters and Tony Brooksnut might be in on some special teams, and that could cause you a little problem.
Yeah, but you got to know where you're supposed to be in a game of this magnitude.
No question about that.
Let's take another look at Tony Rice running the option for the very first time this afternoon, and he ran it so beautifully. But the thing that kind of amazes you is his speed. He just outran everybody down the sideline.
Well, see, the safety man was...
Yeah, Mark Carrier overcommits.
He overcommits because he was worried about kicking the ball out. He took the pitch man. There isn't anybody left on Tony Rice. All he had to do is win a sprint, and he certainly did that.
Well, Mark Green, his own teammate, can't catch him.
Well, that's a big bulge for the Irish, because if they could not run here today against the great defense of Southern Cal, they were in big trouble.
So Notre Dame is out in front by a score of 6-0. On a 65-yard touchdown run, now it is up to Reggie Hull for the fourth after touchdown. Pete Graham is the holder. The snap, the spot, the kick, it's up, and it's right up the middle. 7-0, Notre Dame timeout. Now this for one of Dave Heidemann.
Every day it's like my family's on a merry-go-round. So whatever else I do, every day I make sure they eat right and get their one-a-day vitamins. It has all the essential vitamins and minerals they need. And now they've made one-a-day maximum formula even better with beta-carotene, the nutrient from fruits and vegetables that most of us don't get enough of. And isn't it just like one-a-day to give us more beta-carotene than any other leading brand? I think they did it just for us.
One-a-day, every day, because your health is number one.
Thanks, Mom.
How will you live in the next century? Suddenly, the pace will be quicker. Yet life will be smoother, more comfortable. Introducing the restyled 1989 Buick Century. With premium features you expect from the best-selling Buick on the American road. At a price that will let you enter the next century very comfortably. Welcome to the next century by Buick.
Rice, 65 yards, longest run of his career at Notre Dame. And remember, he has rushed for more yards in a single season than any other Notre Dame quarterback in history. That's his ninth touchdown rushing.
That's the beauty of the option. And Notre Dame gives you so many problems. It isn't just pure option. They're not a wishbone football team. They run a wishbone principle out of the eye. They also fake out of the eye. They also run out of divided backs. They're a multiple offensive team who has really dominated by the running game. And the fact that you've got a running quarterback gives you that fourth alternative. It's a heck of a dangerous thing when you're an offensive football mind.
Now Hackett has it teed up at the 35-yard line. 4:52 left to go in the quarter. Adrenaline flowing. He gets this one down inside the 10. Lockwood to the 5, to the 10, to the 15. Gets to the outside at the 20. Stumbles after being hit and is out of bounds at about maybe the 27-yard line. And it'll be Southern Cal's ball, first down and 10 at that spot. Greg Davis, a backup safety. Remember, the special teams made the stop on the play. So the Irish draw first blood, and now Southern Cal. Let's see how they respond.
You know, Southern Cal, Tony, has never been a team that showed a lot of emotion. That's not their style. They're kind of laid back, if you pardon the expression, but the one thing they are is competitive.
Jackson goes wide to the left. Wellman out to the right. Hand off to Leroy Holt, the fullback. He hits the 30-yard line, and then the Irish defense caves in on him and shoves him back to about the 28. Just about everybody there to make the stop on the play. Linebackers Chris Zorch, the middle guard, the sophomore of Chicago, Illinois, who is certain to be an All-American next year. A gain on the play of about three and a half. And Southern Cal has used the fullback quite extensively in the first part of this game.
Usually it's the tailback that does their running, but you're right. Maybe they see something that we don't.
Aaron Emanuel is the tailback. Holt the fullback. Wellman wide to the right. Affolder out to the left. Here's Rodney Pete back to throw. Set swings it out to Emanuel. Emanuel hit by Jeff Hom. Fumble the ball. Yes, recovered at the 20-yard line. Notre Dame with a recovery at the 20-yard line. And the ball in the hands of Frank Pham.
What a major break for the Irish on the turnover, which makes and breaks football games. If they can take this in with any kind of a score, it's a tremendous psychological edge for the Irish.
The ball belongs to Notre Dame at the 20.
It's a simple little quick screen from Rodney Pete at the depth of the pocket to his tailback.
Yeah, but it was Jeff Hom who made the original hit.
The free ball, yes. Jeff Hom causes the fumble.
Jeff Hom ripped the ball away.
And Frank Stams recovers.
Slot left now for Notre Dame. High tandem, Green the tailback. Here's Rice on the option, turns it upfield, gets 5 yards down to the 15. And Tony Rice managed to get 5 yards, despite the fact that when he pulled away from center, he stumbled.
Well, the hardest thing at all is to run the option, or the hardest thing to defend is to run the option into an open formation. In that case, he was running the option into the slot. So tied up with the slot that it's difficult to play passing on with him.
Braxton Banks, who's from Hayward, California, in at fullback, slot left again for the Irish. This meal is the wideout. Eilers in the slot. On the option, right to Green. Green to the 15. Green down to the 10. Down to the 9. And it's going to be first down and goal to go Notre Dame.
And again, that's the option. They fake the trap by the fullback running right over the guard. They pull the guard. He pulls the ball out, continues down the line, will either keep it or pitch it out. He pitched it out to Mark Green.
Length of the football inside the 9. Hash mark near side. Notre Dame 7. Southern Cal nothing. 3 minutes, 15 seconds. Clock running first quarter. Irish will now go double tight end. They'll also go wishbone formation. Derek Brown in at one tight end. Here's a handoff. The ball going to Green. Green fights his way down to about the 5-yard line. Going to mark it around the 6, so it'll be a gain on the play of about 3. That'll leave it at second down and goal to go, just inside the 6-yard line. Tough to get those yards running inside against the likes of Tim Ryan, Don Gibson, Dan Owen, Michael Williams, Scott Ross, Delmar Chesley, Craig Hartsiker.
This would be a great down for a run action pass. Second down is a perfect down.
Eilers flanked to the right. Notre Dame goes double tight end. I can't once again. Green the tailback. Here's a fake. A handoff to Anthony Johnson. And Johnson snakes through. And he gets down to about the 2-yard line. And it'll be third down and goal to go from that spot now, Tom Pagna. Third down, goal to go, 2 at the Southern Cal 2. What do you call here?
Well, they've got 2 downs to make 3 yards. And they absolutely cannot walk away from this without a score. They've got to either come up with a field goal or a score. They want the score, obviously. I think at this particular junction, give it a wide side right. Look out for a run action pass here.
All right, Braxton Banks has replaced Anthony Johnson at fullback. Handoff off the left side. Mark Green, does he break the plane of the goal line? Touchdown, Irish! Play 20 yards, Notre Dame 13, Southern California nothing.
That was two tight ends, full house backfield, a give to the right halfback going left, a lead by the fullback and left halfback, isolating everybody up front, 2 lead blockers, letting Mark Green power it in.
Mark Green with a great second effort after he'd been stopped near the goal line. Reggie Hall will try for a 4-after touchdown. We are in the first quarter, a minute 49 left to go. Snap, spot, kick up, make it 14-0. Irish, more after this timeout for Sears.
There's only one place you'll find a Craftsman half-horsepower garage door opener with 2 transmitters to open the door and turn on the garage light, too. A special purchase while quantities last, only $149.99. Until Sunday, find this dishwasher, a Kenmore, America's best seller, with 3-level wash for just $288. Save $200. Find these values and a whole lot more, only at Sears.
Martin Green, the senior tailback out of Riverside, California. His sixth rushing touchdown of the year. He now has 13 yards in this game. He is now moved to number 8 on the all-time list of rushers for Notre Dame. He passed Marchie Schwartz. He needs 103 to supplant Neil Wharton, who's got the number 7 spot. The kick by Hackett coming down. Lockwood will take it at the 5, back to the 4. 5, 10, gets to the 15, up to the 20. 25, not quite. Knocked down at the 23-yard line. And it'll be first down and 10 for Southern Cal at that spot. The stop on the play made again by Michael Smalls. He is going to be one heck of a football player, according to Coach Lou Holtz. He's a 6'3", 220-pound freshman from Rialto, California. The ball is at the 24. Now, Rodney Peete, there's a ton of time left, Tom Bagna. A minute 44 left to go in the first quarter. Wide to the left is John Jackson, the junior out of Diamond Bar, California. Affold of the All-American is out to the right. Penalty markers on the play. The Irish started to move across the line of scrimmage. Were they drawn off? Did time run out? What's the story here? Apparently, it is going to be against Southern Cal, and that's going to be our illegal procedure is the call, and that will bring the ball inside the 20, down to the 19-yard line. Tom, if you're a Notre Dame fan, you want to jump up and down. You want to hug the nearest person next to you, even if you like them. If you don't like them, it doesn't make any difference. But there's a lot of time left in this game, and we saw it happen a couple of years ago in the last 12 minutes when the Irish were down by 17. This is not just any series or any two football teams playing in a game.
Well said, Tony. A lot of things can happen yet.
First down and 15 now. Here is Rodney Peete. Back to throw. Fires the pass to the far side. Catch is made. And down at the 30-yard line is John Jackson, the junior in the Diamond Bar. That's his first reception of the day. He will pick up what they lost on the penalty and another 6 yards after that. So it'll be a gain of 9, second down and 4.
You pointed out a little bit earlier that the style of Rodney Peete is a possession-type pass. And the thing about it is the passing game can get you chunks of yardage quickly. That's what they're trying to do or will try to do here.
Deuce backfield slot right. Here come the Irish on the blitz. Hand off to Holt off the left side. Not very far. He will not go very far at all. He got nailed over on the far side by Stanis Magala up around the 32-yard line. So it'll be a gain of a couple on the play. Up to around the 32. And that's going to leave it at third down. And just about 2 yards to go. 2.5 yards to go for a first down.
Southern Cal's having trouble moving the ball against the Irish on the ground. And they're giving a mix on their defense, where they're always sending an extra linebacker, usually an inside linebacker, to throw a monkey wrench in the machinery.
Half holder wide to the left. Jackson is out to the right, and Rodney Peete is back to throw. Fires over the middle. Pass is caught. Catch made and drowned at about the 45-yard line. It's Paul Green, the backup tight end. He is 6'3", 230-pound senior out of Fresno, California, and Southern Cal got first down up at the 45. Notre Dame out in front, 14-0 with 48 seconds left to go in the quarter, but Rodney Peete is now taken to the air.
And that's a good indication of what we're talking about. The Irish sent inside linebacker Wes Pritchett, the tight end, found a daylight area. He's in man coverage, but it's a crossing pattern. Rodney Peete sneaked it in there.
Again, the slot to the left of the short side of the field. The tight end is to the right. Slot man Wellman in motion to the near side. Peete on the handoff to Aaron Emanuel, and he runs right into Chris Zorich. And Zorich knocks him down after getting up to about the 47-yard line, but we also have a penalty marker on the play. 5 seconds showing on the clock here in the first quarter.
Larry Smith, the coach of the Trojans, had said before that he had some doubts about whether or not they'd be able to run the football with consistency against the Irish. Right there is one of the examples of what happens when you run it and don't do the full efficient job. I think they're going to get called for holding.
Meanwhile, Rodney Peete, even though he's got a fellow like Affolder who's an All-American and who leads the nation in reception, Rodney Peete, 6 completions, Tom, 6 different receivers, so he kind of spreads it around.
He really does, and you know, I don't underestimate him. I think he's probably one of the finest quarterbacks, certainly in college football, but maybe one of the finest I've ever seen. And I think that the game that Rodney Peete will turn in here at the end of the day will be one where he'll cover himself with glory.
The first quarter's expired with a score, Notre Dame 14, Southern California nothing. Now this for Keebler.
Which way to South Bend, little Keebler?
Icebox Ike the Enormous Tackle. You're playing against Notre Dame.
I'm going to eat them up.
Gracious, eat these instead.
Tato skins? Skins and all. Terrific.
Tato skin snack chips have big potato appeal.
I like big.
Still going to play Notre Dame?
Nope, going to stay here and watch the game on TV.
Big potato appeal.
Saved by the skin of the potato.
Want to open an early Christmas present?
What? Ruin the surprise? Where is it? Oh, I see Black and Decker.
Oh, a Black and Decker rechargeable flashlight.
It's the brightest rechargeable flashlight you can buy. And because it never needs batteries, it's always ready. It's a present with a future.
Turn off the lights.
Okay.
Ooh, wow.
Is bright.
Hey, you know what else I see?
What?
I see us turning off the lights more often. The rechargeable flashlighter. From Black & Decker.
There's only one place you'll find a Craftsman half-horsepower garage door opener with two transmitters to open the door and turn on the garage light, too. A special purchase while quantities last. Only $149.99. Until Sunday, find this dishwasher. A Kenmore. America's best seller. With three-level wash for just $288. Save $200. Find these values and a whole lot more. Only at Sears.
Here are the first quarter numbers. Southern Cal, 4 first downs of 3 for the Irish. Notre Dame, 94 yards on the ground. Southern Cal, 47. The Irish, 60 yards passing to 35 for Southern Cal. 154 total yards Notre Dame, 82 for the Trojans. 2 of 2 for Tony Rice. 6 of 8 for Rodney Beat. No interception. Southern Cal lost the ball once in a fumble. The Irish turned that turnover into a score. Notre Dame penalty, none, 2 for 15 against Southern Cal. 17 plays for the Trojans and 12 for the Irish. The obvious difference, Tony, is the big play by Tony Rice, 65 yards, and of course the turnover fumble that set up the second score rather easily.
Well, Rice ran 165 yards for a touchdown, and he also fired a 56-yard pass to the Rocket Ismail. Southern Cal on the ball. Jackson starts in motion. Pete back the throw. Sets fires the ball on the side. Here's Paul Green, the tight end, making the grab. And he's going to be out of bounds in front of the Notre Dame bench right around the 43-yard line. His second catch of the afternoon.
The Irish have shown up to this point a mix. As I mentioned, they send out one linebacker inside. They haven't sent an all-out blitz but once or twice early on in the season or early on in the game. However, they can't sit in a zone because Rodney Pete will pick your eyes out.
They picked up 8 from 1st and 20 and is now 2nd down and 12.
And the Irish are in a blitz formation.
Slot to the left. Wellman starts in motion. Pete dropping back. Here comes Notre Dame on the move.
Intercepted. Picked out of the 45. It is Streeter. He's down to the 25. He's down to about the 22-yard line. And Southern Cal has turned it over again. And the Trojans, remember, are right up there on top among the top teams in the country and take away turnover margin.
It was a free safety for Notre Dame that put a blitz on right up the middle. He's unpicked. He's not picked up. And Rodney Pete saw it in his full vision, tried to unload the ball, caught a man in man coverage. Streeter stepped in front of that man, picked it off. A very perfect play on a on the defense's part.
Wes Pritchett was boring in at the time on Rodney Pete. First down for the Irish, slot to the left. Braxton Banks, the fullback. Mark Green looking for an opening, cannot find it, spins out of a tackle, and gets the ball down to about the 21-yard line. Gain on the play will be short. It'll be maybe a couple of yards at the most. It'll be second down and long for the Irish. Second down and about 9 to go for a first down. Eilers coming out of the game now. And into the game is Aaron Robb as a wide receiver. He'll be flanked to the right. The Rocket is out to the left. He'll be covered by Ernest Spears, one of the best pass defenders on Southern Cal's team. Fake to the fullback, and Tony Rice carries, scramble for the loose ball, and I believe Southern Cal has got it. So Rice on a fumble, and Southern Cal has gotten it with Scott Ross, the sophomore from El Toro, California, a linebacker, recovering the fumble by Tony Rice.
Tony, I wouldn't be a bit surprised, thinking the way the flow and the ebb of this game is, that Southern Cal doesn't come out with a first down bomb try. Rodney Pete long to a guy like Gus Wellman or Gary Wellman,
I'll get it right.
It is Gary Wellman.
Gary Wellman. But this is a psychologically the kind of down that you do. It's just it's the counterpart of Lou Holtz throwing out of his end zone. I kind of sense that here.
Rodney Pete now rejoins the Trojan huddle. So the first big break for Southern Cal. They've got the ball first down and 10 at the 22. Jackson is wide to the right. Affolder is out to the left. Here's a handoff to Aaron Emanuel, and he's not going very far. He got nailed by Big George Williams, the sophomore out of Willingsboro, New Jersey. As he hit the line of scrimmage, Williams got a hold of his jersey, tried to yank the ball away, spun him around, and the gain is going to be a short one, a couple of yards. It'll be second down and about 8.
And the sequence of things is that their eye back, Aaron Emanuel, fumbled the series before, looked for, and again, I'm guessing, maybe a fake to the eye back and the bomb, but I do think they have to get the mix of the pass in, otherwise they cannot run on the Irish, and I know they sense that here.
Aaron Emanuel has rushed for 8 touchdowns, despite the fact that he's the number 3 running back for Southern Cal. Tight end is to the right, and Rodney Pete is back to throw. Fires the ball over the middle. The pass is incomplete. And Jennifer Galbraith, the tight end, he was covered by Streeter on the play and by Stan Smigala. That was passed down at the 30-yard line. And it now becomes third down. Third down and 7 to go. And on third down conversion, Southern Cal, 2 of 4. They have been outstanding on third down conversions this year.
Well, I think the defense of Notre Dame at this point will dictate what happens on this down. It's going to be a pass. It's a question of if you're going to force him or zone him, double the receivers or gamble.
Here's Rodney Pete rolling to the right. The pressure coming from the backside. Pete now back to the near side. Looking for a block. Trying to turn it upfield. He throws the ball upfield. The pass is caught by Holt at the 45. And knocked out of bounds at about the 48-yard line. Is a fullback, Leroy Holt. And a great bit of ad-libbing by Rodney Pete. You got to surround him. You got to pretend he's George Armstrong Custer or he's going to hurt you.
I mentioned it before. The defense will dictate what happens. If you get him in a scrambling position, he's playing his best game. That was good for a pickup of 23 yards, made something out of nothing.
Jeff Hall was the man who forced him to the outside and forced him to throw the ball. But Leroy Holt came to the near side and got Rodney Pete out of trouble. He bailed him out, and it'll be first down for Southern Cal at the Trojan 48-yard line. Aaron Emanuel is the tailback. Half-hold of the wideout to the left. Here is Pete looking. Fires the ball over the middle. The pass is caught by Aaron Emanuel, and he's nailed in his tracks at the Notre Dame 43-yard line. It'll be a gain on the play of almost 9 yards will set up second down and short for Southern Cal.
You've seen the Irish use that virtually the same play. You fake to the eye back kind of makes a haphazard fake, moseys on through for about 5 or 6 yards, and when everybody else is off in coverage, you dunk him the ball, and it's a sure game.
9 out of 13 for Rodney Pete, 74 yards, intercepted one time. Second down and short. And Pete now looking, rolling to the right, throwing the ball on the run. The pass is caught, and stepping out of bounds is John Jackson at the Irish 35-yard line. And Rodney Pete is no flash in the pan. The last 7 games this season, he has thrown for 16 touchdowns. He has completed 65% of his passes and has been intercepted only 3 times.
When he rolls out to the wide side of the field and throws on the run, and he does it equally well both to the left and to the right, Rodney Pete is a dimension unto himself. He really is.
First down and 10, Southern Cal at the Irish 35-yard line. Notre Dame on top, 14-0. We're in the second quarter. Wellman starts with motion to the near side from flank or right. Pete dropping back to throw. On the blitz, Andre Jones had him for a moment, and the pass intended for the tight end Scott Galbraith, incomplete. But Andre Jones, one of the fastest linebackers for the Irish, on the rush, found the gap, and put the pressure on the Southern Cal quarterback. And Tom Pagans, I don't care who you are, Rodney Pete, Dan Marino, John Elway, if the pressure is there, you're going to have a tough time completing it.
Yeah, it's a real gamble by the Irish. Two blitz because it puts you in man coverage. The last time they won that gamble with George Streeter in excellent coverage, I think you're going to see more of the same. But remember this, one of the greatest partners in the game is Rodney, so you can get burned just as easily as not.
Second down and 10 at the 35. Offset high slot right. Pete back to throw. Look to the right. Pass deflected. And it was George Williams who got a hand on the ball. Big George Williams, the big defensive left tackle, got his hands on the ball. He's 6'3", 282 pounds. From Willingboro, New Jersey, got his left hand up and deflected the ball.
And the Irish, knowing this is going to be a third and long situation, sure passing down, have put in their dime package, six defensive backs. So they'll take out two linebackers, and they'll put in the six defensive backs and go with a double coverage on the two wideouts.
Officials have called a timeout here for just a moment. The ball at the 35. It'll be third down and 10. Eric Appholder went out. Looks like he got injured. He's limping a little bit. Southern Cal certainly doesn't want to lose him. Wellman is wide to the left. Jackson is out to the right. Deuce backfield for Rodney Pete. Are the Irish coming out of blitz? Pete takes it, and here they come. Here is Pete rolling to the left, being chased now. Looking to throw, still being chased back to the other side. He's back to the 40-yard line, far as the pass, far side. It is broken up by Dan Spagala. Dan Spagala on John Jackson, and Rodney Pete tried the transcontinental route. He was rolling to his left, being pressured, turned around, and tried to throw the ball all the way across the field to the right side.
The Irish have had great success against him thus far by blitzing the inside. That's the shortest distance to go to get to the quarterback when he goes to the pocket. And, of course, playing double sometimes and sometimes single coverage on the wideouts.
Chris Burrell, who can kick the ball very, very high, will try a pooch kick here. Will try to get the ball very high and down deep. Notre Dame has nobody back to receive the punt. Low snap on one hop, and Burrell with a high punt. And he might have shanked that one off his foot. It hits and starts bouncing upfield, and it's going to be down at the 20-yard line, so the Irish get a break. 15-yard punt on the play. This is Notre Dame football on Mutual.
Now, Tidy Cat 3 is a hard-working cat box filler.
Tidy Cat 3, when you go, it deodorizes better, absorbs like a real go-getter, leaves no dust, no tracks around, Tidy Cat 3.
I'm Ed Lowe. My Tidy Cat 3 is 99% dust-free, so it's cleaner and healthier for your cat. And with my Tidy Cat 3 cat box liners, you may never have to wash your cat box again.
Notre Dame 14, Southern California nothing. 11 minutes and 53 seconds left to play in the first half. And a reminder that at the end of today's game, we'll be picking the Lionel Crane's offensive player of the game. After the game, the Lionel Crane's offensive player of the game will be brought to you by Lionel Crane, the training ground, and the recipient of that offensive player award. Well, a Lionel Crane set will be awarded to that player's favorite charity. Right now, the Irish have the football first down and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Ismail is out, and Stan Steve Alanese, the senior out of Edinburgh, Texas, is in the game as a wide receiver. Cody Rice, if you're joining us late, 65 yards off the left side on the quarterback option for a touchdown. And then we had Mark Green going in from a yard out, from a couple of yards out for the second score. First and 10 Notre Dame at the 20-yard line. Eilers wide to the right. Here's the handoff, and Anthony Johnson goes absolutely nowhere. The middle of that Southern California line just did not budge. Everybody stayed right where they were. Ryan, Gibson, Owens, the linebackers came up. No game up. Maybe a gain of a half yard on the play. We'll call it one. To be generous, make it second down, a long nine.
I don't think the Irish anticipated a 14-0 lead. So
well, they can't sit on it either.
That's right. Exactly right.
Throw set this time with Johnson in the backfield along with Green. Here's Rice firing the pass. The field intended for Mark Green, just a little too much arm. Tony Rice needed just a little softer touch on that, and Mark Green did an outstanding job of trying to haul in that football, diving for it, and having it trickle off his fingertips.
Tony, if he doesn't, I think it becomes an interception because the safety was zeroed in on it.
First incompletion for Tony Rice. second down and make that third down and nine. He's two out of three for the afternoon. Again, the pro set. Again, the wideouts both sides. And Cody Rice on the quarterback draw to the 20 and stumbles forward to about the 26-yard line. Well, one official was going to mark it at the 26. They'll say his knee touched the ground at the 25. So with fourth down and five, now it'll be up to Jim Sexton to punt the football. Irish tried a quarterback draw to try to negate the rush of the Southern Cal defensive unit.
Scott Lockwood is back for the Trojans to return the punt. He's had great success. He's a sure-handed, good runner, a 4-4 sprinter speed type of guy, 5'10", 195.
And he's out at the 30-yard line. Sexton with a punt. Lazy spiral coming up. He'll be taken at the 33-yard line, to the 35, to the 40, and Pat Terrell bumps him out of bounds somewhere around the 42. We've got a timeout. The score is 14-0 Irish. Now this is for Progresso.
Match up your football tradition with the long tradition of Progresso's delicious family of soups. Bring a big container of Progresso to your next tailgate party. Hot and hearty Progresso soups are the ideal way to warm up before and after the game. Enjoy our hearty chicken and chicken noodle, packed with generous chunks of chicken, a garden full of vegetables, and sunny Italian flavor. So remember, next time you tailgate, there's no soup like Progresso.
Where can you find soft, comfortable Oaks Unlimited flannel shirts of 100% cotton? Right now, buy one $15 shirt at regular price and get a second one free. And find Levi's stonewashed jeans with the famous Levi fit in 100% heavyweight cotton denim for only $17.88, a special purchase while quantities last. Find all this and a whole lot more now, only at Sears.
14-0 Irish, and a reminder, Tuesday night's on Mutual, the final Lou Holtz show of the season. Call the coach between 8 and 9 Eastern Time, 1-800-634-3881. The last Lou Holtz show of the year, Tuesday night, on Mutual. Lou talk with Mutual Sports Director Larry Michael. Eric Affolder, who is the 13th in the country. I said he was number one. He's number one with USC. He's 13th in the nation receptions. Limping a little bit, but on the playing field right now. Single season receiving leader. 118 career catches coming into this game, and that ties him with Hank Norman. As a matter of fact, did he caught one this game? Okay, so he's now the new all-time leader. Here's the handoff to Aaron Emanuel, and he's not going very far. Gets up from the 42 to about the 43 or 44 yard line. Frank Stamson company, the Irish defense not wanting to move out there. Making the stop, Ned Volkar. Linebacker Michael Stonebreaker is also out there. So it'll be second down and about 9 yards to go for a first down. Second and nine with the ball at the 43.
Chris Zorich, the nose guard for the Irish, really made a great contribution on it. He stood up the center and kind of moseyed down and closed the gap where there was to read.
Second down and nine. Flanker left, wide out right. Deuce backfield, handoff to Leroy Holt. Holt stopping at the line of scrimmage, and then he runs right into number 50, Chris Zorich, and takes him upfield a couple of yards from the 45 up to about the 46 or 47-yard line. Stonebreaker made the stop on the play, grabbed him around the ankle. So now it is going to be third down, and still a good 5 yards to go for a first down.
Well, no one has run with any great consistency against the Irish this season. If any team can, because of the size of the offensive line, I thought the Trojans could, but I think they have to resort more to the mix, the pass and the run, run action pass.
Both six carries, 32 yards. Aaron Emanuel, 5 for 22, so they're the leading rushers for Southern Cal. Irish coming on a blitz. Here's Rodney Pete having to hurry his throw. Catch is made in an excellent reception on the far side. What a nice catch made out there by Eric Affolder, and he's finally dropped in his tracks by Juan Francisco, but it'll be enough for a first down, and the Irish were coming on the blitz, and Rodney Pete just managed to get the ball off.
You notice that they did that from divided backs. That means that both of the backs can step up and pick up crashing linebackers to give him just a moment of time to play pitch and catch with Eric Affolder.
8 yards on the play. It'll be a first down. They're in Notre Dame territory at the Irish 46. I-Tand of flanker right in motion. Affolder coming to the near side. Rodney Pete, play action, back to throw. Sets, fires a pass. It is caught at the 35-yard line. Catch is made, and it's going to be a first down for Southern Cal. An 11-yard pickup on the play, and this time it is Wellman. He is a sophomore out of Westlake Village,
his second reception of the afternoon, and Southern Cal, unable to move the ball on the ground, is now taken to the air.
One of the things that freezes linebackers is a good run-action fake. They have such a potent eye backfield tandem, and when you stick the ball in the tailback's hands and he fakes it into the line, it does freeze linebackers. 12 for 19 is Rodney Pete for 102 yards.
The ball at the 34. Jackson starts in motion to the right from flank or left. Pete being chased there by Zorich. Now throws the ball on the run. The pass is incomplete. Threw the ball away into the crowd. So Rodney Pete, with a lot of pressure, throws the ball away. And again, the Irish coming on the blitz. And Frank Sams taking that loop, and Rodney Pete forcing him to throw the football. So now we've got second down and 10 from the 34. Have to remember that Rodney Pete ranked sixth in the NCAA among the nation's passers. He's got 102 yards, and we still have 8:14 left to go in the first half. He's been averaging something like 147 yards a game throwing.
Looks like a blitz formation.
Here's Rodney Pete handing it off to Aaron Emanuel. Emanuel snaking through and gets inside the 35, down to about the 31-yard line. At second down and 10, it's going to be third down and still a good 6 yards to go for a first down.
One of the things that happens when you run out of the eye is it takes time. It takes time for a guy that is aligned 7 yards deep to get to the line of scrimmage. The Irish this year are perhaps the quickest defensive team that we've witnessed over the last 5 years.
4 of 7 on third down conversion. 4 of 7 on third down conversion. Pete rolls to the right, look, fires a long pass down the right sideline toward the end zone, incomplete. Overthrow his man, and that was John Jackson. Jackson had Todd Light beat by about a step, but Rodney Pete would not put the ball on the money. And with fourth down coming up, little decision time here for Coach Larry Smith.
Well, I think, you know, when you're 14 points down, it's middle of the second quarter, he's going to go for it, and he's going to go with his best suit, because Rodney Pete, fourth is no different than third, has a great third down completion percentage.
Marlon Washington, a junior out of Kansas City, Kansas, in the game as a wide receiver left. Out to the right is Gary Wellman. Slot to the right side. Eric Affolder in the slot, the All-America receiver. Rodney Pete, back to throw. Sets, looks, fires the ball over the middle. The pass is almost intercepted by Todd Light. Now we got a penalty marker on the play.
It was a crossing pattern. And whenever you get a crossing pattern, you get any kind of man coverage, you got somebody chasing. It's a reaction. There might have been some contact. That's what they've called.
So it'll be a penalty against the Irish. That's the first Notre Dame penalty. Marlon Washington was the intended receiver, and there was definitely contact before, and the penalty will be against Corny Southall. Southall hit him in the back. Southall tried to run through the intended receiver, and in doing so, bumped up against his back. It'll be first down, Southern Cal, at the Irish 19, and this is the deepest incursion into Notre Dame territory in the first half by the Trojans.
I will not be a bit surprised, Tony, if the Irish don't come right out with first down blitz.
Wide to the right, Affolder and Wellman. Washington out to the left. I tend up for Rodney Pete. Notre Dame nursing a 14-0 advantage. Hand off and the ball going to fumble on the play. Who's got it? The Irish have recovered. The ball went to, I believe, Holt. And up with the ball to George Williams. The third turnover of the game by Southern Cal. We've got a timeout with the score. Notre Dame 14 and Southern California nothing. This is Notre Dame football on Mutual.
I was 20 years younger, I'd be playing for Notre Dame. Desmond Crofton, proprietor of Kennedy's, the fine Irish restaurant on 2nd Avenue and 52nd Street, and his passion for football is only equaled by his passion for making Kennedy's the finest taste of true Irish dining you'll ever have. Desmond?
Call me Desi.
Well, Desi, we've heard about Notre Dame. How about Kennedy?
Just bring your appetites and a taste for the good life, and Kennedy's will take care of the rest in grand style.
With Irish smoked salmon.
A miraculous mouthful.
And Kennedy's famous Irish mixed grill.
A dazzling display of deliciousness.
Spoken as a true Irishman, Desi, but could we get to basics?
What about Notre Dame?
How about Kennedy?
The people have to come to Kennedy's and taste the magic.
Like the prime rib?
And feel the warmth of our cozy fireplace and hear our joyous piano. Now, come on, Notre Dame.
You're impossible, Desi. Possibly Irish.
That's Kennedy's. Irish can be, with a lot of class and a bit of the blarney.
Just a week.
Kennedy's on 2nd Avenue and 52nd Street.
Third Southern California turnover in the first half. Now remember, the Trojans came into this game a plus 17. They were third in the country in takeaway turnovers. 14 fumble recoveries, 17 interceptions, plus 31. They turned the ball over five times on fumbles coming into this game. Nine interceptions, minus 14, so they were a plus 17. The Irish, meanwhile, were 13th in the nation. They took the ball away from the opposition 14 times on fumbles, 69 interceptions, plus 30. But they gave it up 12 times on fumbles, nine times on interceptions, minus 21, a plus 9. First down and 10. Anthony Johnson at fullback. Mark Green, the tailback. Hand off to Green. Green off the right side to the 23-yard line. Gain of a couple of yards. Notre Dame not getting much on first down. Rushing as the tackle again is made by Dan Owens and also by Delmar Chesley. So it'll be second down on the play at about 8 yards to go for a first down. And Notre Dame may have to come out throwing on first down to kind of loosen up that defense.
I think they will, Tony, but they don't have to at this point because of the 14-point bulge. They would like to move the ball, though, with some consistency.
Irish have had the ball for only six offensive plays in this quarter. Slot left, I-tandem, fake to the fullback. Back to throw, Rice firing down the far side. Incomplete, intended for Derek Brown, who is double-covered on the play by the Trojans. Mark Carrier was down there, along with Ernest Spears, two of their better defenders. So that'll be third down now and 8 yards to go for a first down.
They run a three-play sequence. It's either the trap give to the fullback, the fake of that trap option, or make the trap and run action pass, which is the play that we just witnessed there. That three-play sequence has served them well through the course of this year.
Clock stops, 6:44 left to go. Notre Dame on their own 23, third down and 8. Throw set, slot to the left for the Irish. And Tony Rice dropping back, sets, look, in trouble. Fires a pass near side, nobody there. No one was there. Now the crowd, of course, predominantly Southern California Trojan crowd, complaining that there should have been a grounding call here, but he can throw the ball anywhere he liked it. Rodney Pete did the same thing when being pressured, threw the ball into the Notre Dame bench. So with fourth down coming up, another punt by Sexton, 33 and 41 thus far. Lockwood for Southern Cal, back at the Trojan 32. Sexton for the Irish at the Notre Dame 10. The rush is on, he gets the punt off. Spirals the ball upfield. Lockwood will watch the ball bounce. It bounces high, he takes it at the 33 and gets nailed. Oh, Lockwood made a cardinal mistake there. He had a great opportunity to run it back by catching the ball on the fly and did not do it. 14-0 the score. Timeout. Now this for General Motors.
The tires on a 1989 General Motors car or light-duty truck are covered by the tire maker's warranty. Every other part is backed by GM for 3 years or 50,000 miles. Every part. GM calls it the bumper-to-bumper plus warranty. General Motors is the first American car maker to express that kind of confidence in the quality of its cars, vans, and pickups. See your GM dealer for terms and conditions of this limited warranty. See how teamwork and technology build confidence in GM quality.
3 a.m. I want a Twinkie. So dark. Aha. I found you. Ooh, boy. There's strawberry in my Twinkie. Discover new fruit and cream Twinkies with real strawberries swirled inside its creamy middle. Original Twinkies, too. Gee, can a man eat in peace?
Notre Dame 14, Southern California nothing. We're in the second quarter, 6:29 left to go. On our Sears scoreboard, Houston 45, Rice 14. Miami with a field goal late over Arkansas, 18-16, a final. Also a final, Georgia over Georgia Tech, 24-3. That's our Sears scoreboard. Sears, where you get your money's worth and a whole lot more. Southern Cal with the ball, first down and 10. The ball at the Trojan 34-yard line. Rodney Pete with back split, wide outs both sides. Tight end is to the right. Hands the ball off to Holt. Holt gets away from Volkar, but coming up to Magana from the left corner to make the tackle on the play and drop him right around the line of scrimmage. and it happened to be Chris Zorich, the nose guard, the 260-pound nose guard out of Chicago.
It was going to be a draw, something over the right guard position, and it was so jammed up that Holter had to read it all the way to the outside. Smagala supported too quickly.
Wellman comes wide to the left. Affolter is split out to the right. Play action fake. Rodney Pete looking for Affolter to pass. Batted down. Batted down at the line of scrimmage. Well, I believe it was Zorich who got a hand on it and swatted the ball down. So that's going to set it up a third down situation.
Tony, I think it was
Zorich or Jeff Alm.
No, Jeff Alm.
Jeff Alm, the tree. Oh. Yeah, well, Alm deflected the ball and then Zorich knocked the ball down. Well, Jeff Alm has had a defensive lineman's dream year. Three interceptions. Plus, I don't know how many PBUs he has. Passes broken up. Third and 11 for Southern Cal. For the first time, we look at Rodney Pete in the shotgun. Steps back, takes the snap, rolls out to the left. Look, throws the ball over the middle. The pass is caught at the 50. It's Affolter down to the 45, down to the 40, and a first down for Southern Cal. His third catch of the day.
Tony, that's vintage Rodney Pete. When he took the ball in the shotgun, felt the pressure, rolled out to his left, he bought some time. It allowed Affolter to shake his defensive man, and to put the ball on the money so accurately on the run to your left is an indication of what we talked about earlier.
10th first down for Southern Cal, only three for Notre Dame, 25 yards on the play. First down and 10 in Irish territory once again. The Trojans pressing the Irish defense. Hand off to Aaron Emanuel. Emanuel down to the 40, down to the 39-yard line, and that's as far as he's going to go. Now a penalty marker on the play. Well, what happened here was Jeff Alm was being ridden on a block by Southern Cal's Scott Galbraith, the tight end, and Alm took a swipe at him. The play was over, and he continued to try to block him, so it's going to be a personal foul against the Irish.
Jeff Alm immediately called to the sideline and have a little conversation with Coach Holt, saying, hey, nobody's worth 15 yards down here, baby.
So the ball is inside the 25, down to the 24-yard line. Galbraith was just not lit up, and Alm, and you know, the funny part about that is the official's right on the play. The play is over. He's watching Galbraith continually try to block Alm, and he doesn't blow the whistle or doesn't stop it. First down and 10. Handoff, the ball going to Holt, and Holt's not going very far. Maybe the Irish got their dander up. Got maybe a yard down to the 23-yard line as the Notre Dame defense caves in on him. So it'll be a gain of 1 second down and 9. Rodney Pete on 16 Southern California records.
Gary Wellman just entered the, they call plays with John Jackson, Gary Wellman alternate, but Wellman again has 4.35 speed.
And Rodney, of course, third in Pac-10 career passing and the total offense list. Been outstanding. Back to throw to the near side. The pass is caught, and Affolter goes out of bounds at the 15-yard line. Magala, it was a timing pattern, just had no chance to defend on the play, and it'll be just short of the first down at the 15-yard line.
And Wes Pritchett, an inside linebacker blitz, was in his space, unblocked, but Rodney Pete's quick retreat and release saved him a negative yardage play.
14 out of 24 for Rodney Pete, 135 yards. Third down and a yard, the ball inside the 16-yard line. Jackson goes wide to the right, double tight end. Emanuel is the tailback, long count by Rodney Pete. Who will get the call? The toss to Emanuel. Emanuel down to the 15, inside the 15, down to about the 11-yard line. Closer to the 12, it'll be first down and 10 at the 12-yard line of Notre Dame.
Something in the way of strategy here. When you go with two tight ends, it forces your weak side linebacker, who is usually a little lighter weight guy that's involved in pass coverage, to align over a tight end. Andre Jones, in this case, has to align over a 235-pound tight end and be blocked by him. And that's what they did that time. They put that tight end to the short side of the field and ran into it.
Holt, the fullback, 8 carries, 33 yards. Emanuel, the tailback, 8 carries for 30 yards. First down and 10.
Here's a toss, sweeping left. It is Emmanuel down to the 10. Emmanuel hit and knocked down, down around the 7-yard line. At least five Notre Dame tacklers, and Wes Pritchett was a man who grabbed him around the ankle and dropped him. But it'll be a gain on the play of about 4 yards, almost five. It'll be second down at about 5.5 to go for a first down.
That's three consecutive running plays we have seen to the short side of the field, to the left side for the offensive Trojans. And I think they're trying to run to that run side, weak side, because of George Streeter's quick support on the other side.
Half-holder wide to the right along with Jackson in the slot. Here's the handoff, Emmanuel down to the five, down to the goal line, did not make it. He stopped at the half-yard line. It'll be first down and goal to go. First down and goal to go. Pat Carroll made a touchdown-saving tackle for the Irish.
Remember, Aaron Emmanuel had an early fumble. He's got a lot to prove here today. There's 3 minutes and 32 seconds before the half. The Trojans want to get it in. The Irish want to hold him out.
Emmanuel on that quick burst up the middle broke two tackles and finally got stopped by Pat Carroll down around the goal line. Ah, the Irish would like to have that 15 yards back on that penalty, wouldn't they?
Certainly would.
First down and goal to go. High tandem, handoff to Aaron Emmanuel, did not make it. He tried to leap over the break the plane of the goal line. The Irish came up with a football. He's down at the half-yard line. Notre Dame met him on the leap and stopped him in midair.
Of all the plays in football, Tony, and I know you've heard me say this so repeatedly that it's really boring, except for the fact that it's true, that's the slowest hitting play on the goal line that you could possibly call. The best play is a quarterback sneak.
11th play coming up in this drive. 11th play coming up in this drive. I believe it was Juan Francisco who made the stop on the play. Second down, goal to goal from the half-yard line. Here's the toss, sweeping left. It's Lockwood, touchdown, Southern Cal. 11 plays, 66 yards, and the Trojans are on the board. And the point after could cut the Irish margin in half.
Lockwood took a pitch out from the tailback position, was going wide. They were in very tight splits. The Irish started to move laterally. The blocking kicked them from the inside out. Lockwood cut it in behind to gain 1 yard and the touchdown.
The point after touchdown attempt now by Quinn Rodriguez. He is a left-footed shocker-style kicker, a sophomore out of Mesa, Arizona. The spot, the kick, it's up, and it is good. It is now 14-7, Notre Dame. More after this special 30-second message.
The birth of an innocent little baby should be the happiest time in a mother's life, and it can be, unless she has AIDS. Many women carry the AIDS virus and don't even know it. If they become pregnant, their babies could have AIDS. So if you think you've been exposed, the March of Dimes Birth Defects Foundation urges you to get the AIDS test before you get pregnant. Because a baby born with AIDS is born dying.
So Southern Cal with a 66-yard drive that was aided and abetted by a 15-yard penalty, a personal foul call against the Irish. That certainly helped Southern Cal. Not that they might not have scored anyway, because they have been relentless in their pressure against the Notre Dame defense.
They certainly have, Tony. Rodney Pete is a big play guy. We've said that. There were a couple of key plays where he made up some individual effort things that they looked like they were locked at 3rd and 9, but he rolled out and hit a receiver for to keep that drive alive.
Look at what Southern Cal's defense has done to Notre Dame. 94 yards rushing. 60 passing in the first quarter. That's 154 yards. The second quarter, Notre Dame 9 yards on the ground, nothing passing.
Hard to figure. They play in spurts, both offensively and defensively.
Now, Rodriguez will kick. Anthony Johnson on the near side, Braxton Banks on the far, and the rocket. And the Irish right now really need a big play from Ragib Ismail, the freshman from Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania. And the kick. It'll come down, and who's going to take it? Out and watch the ball bounce. It bounces back to Braxton Banks at the 50. He's at the 20. He fights his way to the 25-yard line. And it'll be first down and 10 for Notre Dame at that spot. And that Tom Pagnett could have turned out to be a disaster.
One of the things you try to coach your receiving team to do is never, ever let the ball hit the ground. The ground is treacherous when you're dealing with an oval. The bounce won't be true.
So it is first down and 10 for the Irish, who see their lead cut in half now, 14-7, as Southern California has dominated the second quarter of this contest. Notre Dame going to the wishbone. Here's a quick cross, and Mark Green not able to go anywhere. Tim Ryan knifing in to make the stop on the play, the junior from San Jose, California. And it'll be a loss of 5. It'll be second down and 15. We also have a penalty marker on the play. It is against Notre Dame.
Well, they went almost the entire first half without a penalty. I think they had that one 15-yarder and a 5-yarder before that. All of a sudden, it's working against them.
So the ball is marked at the 19-yard line. And it's going to be second down at about 15 yards to go for the first down. Aaron Robb comes into the game very late. Now they've got too many people on the field, and Robb's going to have to hurry to get off the field. Slot to the left for the Irish. And Tony Rice back to throw. Set brings it out to the near side. It's Green to the 20. Green to the 25-yard line. He's back to the original line of scrimmage. The pass by Tony Rice was low, and Mark Green had to take that one off the grass tops, which meant that he was a little delayed in getting the ball upfield, and it is now third down and 10.
It's a hard screen to actually execute because Mark Green, coming out of the backfield, starts to his left, tries to weave his way hidden through the line or the charging line and find himself in the right flat.
That ball may have touched the ground. So Aaron Robb is wide to the left as the flanker. The rocket is out to the right. And Tony Rice looking to throw. Pass near side. Catch is made, but it won't be enough for the first down. Derrick Brown making his first catch of the afternoon and bumped down at about the 28-yard line. Make that his second catch of the afternoon. And with fourth down coming up, and the crowd now in a frenzy because the Irish, facing fourth down and 7, are going to have to punt the football.
All of a sudden, and I don't know how it happened, there's a turn in momentum here, Tony. Southern Cal looks like a different ball club on the field.
We've got 1 minute left to go in the first half. 14-7 Notre Dame, and the Irish are going to be forced to punt. 33, 41, and 44 yards. And last time that Sexton punted, Lockwood made a mistake and let the ball bounce, or he had a chance to take the ball on the run, bring the ball upfield, did not do it. It didn't matter anyway because they put the ball in play at the 34-yard line, and Southern Cal just took it 66 yards downfield. And the difference in this ball game, when you look at the statistics, not at the score, but the statistics, is Rodney Peet.
Yes. You know, there's another element involved with the punt. They know that Sexton is not necessarily a quick punter. He's a pretty solid one, though. They had a rush on him last time with 10 people. Scott Lockwood was the only one back. This time we might see a block because he's going to field that ball somewhere around his own 35.
Lockwood is the man who is back. And he'll be standing at about the 33-yard line. Drops back to the 32. Sexton for the Irish at the 16-yard line. Each team has 2 timeouts remaining. 60 seconds left to play in the first half. Helmet high snap. Here's the punt, and it's checked by Sexton. It comes upfield. It bounces. It'll be grabbed by Streeter at the 50-yard line, and the ball will go to Southern Cal at the 50 with 52 seconds left to play. A 21-yard punt.
Well, now you got 52 seconds before the half. Trojans trailing 14-7. You're going to see Rodney Peet go into their 2-minute routine. Actually, it's a 1-minute routine. They're going to do the kinds of things that will stop the clock and advance the ball, which will be out patterns or long throws into the end zone.
It is first down and 10, Southern Cal. They'll operate from the shotgunner at the Irish 49-yard line.
Rodney Peake with a slot right in the wide out left. Throws the ball right over the middle. The pass is intercepted. Picked off by the Irish. It's Magana. Magana to the 30, to the 20. He's down to the 10, the 5. A touchdown. That's Magana. Picked off Rodney Peake and returns it for a score.
Rodney Peake is laying down on the field, Tony. He took a blow. I don't believe anybody's ever returned the pass all the way for an interception against him. It was a kind of a point of pride with him, but he's hurt on this particular play.
The fourth turnover of the first half by Southern California. Oh, Stance McGuire threw a bead on that pass and just took it on the dead run, and no one touched him.
Stance McGuire has 4.35 speed and outran what remained of the defensive pursuit.
He's dropping back to throw, fired that ball right over the middle, and boy, Smagala was right there. The pass was intended for John Jackson. 65 yards, another big play for the Irish.
It wasn't on the pass rush that Rodney Peake took the blow. It was on the, after the interception, he came over to try to help with the tackle, got blocked by a Notre Dame football player, and really took it right smack to the ground.
Want to talk about turn of fortune?
Yes.
Oh, boy, he's walking off the field. Now he's trotting off the field under his own power. As I said, four turnovers.
Well, four turnovers says an awful lot about the score.
Especially from the number three team in the country in takeaways and turnovers. Reggie Hall will try for the PAT. Pete Graham, the holder. Here's the spot. The kick is up, and it is off to the right. I believe it was no good. It went off to the right. That could play a big, big part in the outcome of this game. We'll have more right after this timeout for Sears.
There's only one place you'll find a Craftsman half-horsepower garage door opener with two transmitters to open the door and turn on the garage light, too. A special purchase while quantities last. Only $149.99. Until Sunday, find this dishwasher, a Kenmore, America's best seller, with three-level wash for just $288. Save $200. Find these values and a whole lot more. Only at Sears.
Tom, why don't you turn on the light?
Because I'm trying out my new Magnavox camcorder.
Bet you could hardly see anything.
My brother, see, you know, that's the point. This new Magnavox camcorder takes great pictures in low light, daylight, or practically no light at all, see?
Now, that's pretty smart.
Yeah, and the thing is, it's fully automatic, too.
That's a perfect camcorder for you.
Yeah, why's that?
You've been in the dark for years.
Oh, thank you very much.
That was not a compliment.
Oh, yeah?
Magnavox. Smart choice. Very smart.
Tom Pagner, Reggie Hall misses the point after. Your computer mind starts clicking. What if? What do we do when we get a chance for another score?
Well, I think you got to gamble for the two because with 20-7, you got a whole second half to face here. You're facing a passer. You can't play the odds.
A bouncing ball picked up, fumbled, picked up once again. Brought out to the 30-yard line, up to about the 35, getting up to about the 40-yard line. And I believe it was Jeff Brown, who was a backup fullback from Balboa Island, California. We have 34 seconds left to go. And with Rodney Peake back at quarterback, anything can happen. We're going to pause briefly here for station identification. This is Mutual, your network leader in radio sports.
You are listening to AM 1130 WNEW, New York.
So the ball is at the 40-yard line. And the Irish certainly did not want to give Southern Cal an opportunity to have the ball in that kind of field position. Rodney Peake working from under center, hands the ball off to Holt. Holt to the 45, Holt to the 50, to Notre Dame territory, down to the Irish 47-yard line. 29 seconds left. 14 first down for Southern California. 3 for Notre Dame. None in the second half.
That's amazing. That's an amazing stat.
Here's Rodney Peake from the shotgun. Back to throw. Has the time. Gets hit. Gets away from Frank Stan. Throws the ball long downfield. Pass is intercepted and then dropped. In and out of the hands of Todd Light down at the 10-yard line. Make that Pat Darrell.
Well, Gary Wellman made a tremendous hit on Pat Terrell because Terrell had an interception. Wellman smacked him, knocked the ball loose, and saved that interception. Incidentally, Tony, it was Frank Stams that blocked Rodney Peake on that interception return by Stance Magala.
Well, Frank Stams had a hold of Rodney Peake, but he's very, very elusive and just could not latch on to him and bring him down, and Pete got the pass off.
Talk about sensing pressure, he does.
Second down and 10. The ball is at the Irish 47 from the shotgun. Pete rolling out to the left, looking to throw. Look, look, it's hit, not this time. He's dropped at the 45-yard line. Dan says, I didn't get you the first time, but I got you the second time. And is Rodney Pete down? Nope, he's up on his feet. And he is hurting a little bit, Coach.
That's the first sack of the game for the Irish.
Well, we've got 5 seconds left to go in the first half. And a timeout has been called here by Southern California. And Rodney Pete, he's walking back to that, walking back to the sideline, and he's hurting a little bit. 7-yard loss on the play. 7-yard loss on the play. And for the Irish, remember, Notre Dame came into this game 19 sacks. Now, figure this. Notre Dame, 19 sacks, 115 yards. Southern California, 41 sacks for 234 yards in losses.
We were matching two really great football teams here today. A lot of explosion. There hasn't been one moment that hasn't been electric in that first half.
Third down and 18 to go. The ball is back at the Trojan 45-yard line. 5 seconds left to play. Notre Dame 20 and Southern California 7. Interception returned by Stan Smigala. By the way, that is his first interception of the year. And the Irish, who came into the game with 16 interceptions, now have 2 in this contest, gives them 18. We're going to have backup quarterback Pat O'Hara. He's from Santa Monica, California. Hasn't taken many snaps. He will take the snap. He'll hand the ball off to Holt, and Holt will get up to the 50-yard line. That's as far as he will go. The first half is history. The score at the end of one half of play, Notre Dame 20 and Southern California 7. Now this for the Discover Card. Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum, Notre Dame 20, Southern California 7 at the half. I'm Tony Roberts along with Tom Pagna. The Irish scoring, second series, started at their own 28. Tony Rice on the quarterback option, around the left side, 65 yards for touchdown. The Irish have the lead by a score of 7-0. The first time in the game that Tony Rice ran the football. Next series, Frank Stams recovers a fumble at the Southern California 20-yard line. Mark Green punches it in from 2 yards out, and the Irish have a 14-0 lead with a minute 49 left to go in the first quarter. Then a succession of turnovers, one by Notre Dame, one by Southern California. No scoring until Lockwood went in from a yard out, as Southern Cal went 66 yards to cut the Irish margin in half, 14-7. Notre Dame had the punt, a bad punt, a 21-yard shank. Southern Cal took the ball over at the Irish 49-yard line. Rodney Pete dropping back the throw. Throws the ball down the left side. Meanwhile, Dan Smigala comes out of nowhere, draws the beat on the ball, picks it off and returns it 64 yards for a touchdown with 41 seconds left to go, 20-7. Reggie Hoek missed the point after. Notre Dame takes that margin into the locker room. 20-7, Notre Dame out in front. We'll be back with more right after this.
Now huddled on the sideline down around the 40 to 45 to the 50-yard line. They won the toss deferred, and that means that Southern Cal is going to be kicking off here in the second half of play. And we'll get to see the rocket, Raghib Ismail. And, of course, Southern Cal will try not to kick the ball to him.
On the other hand, on the other side of the field, when their offense takes the field, I think a main key will be the how well Rodney Pete has recuperated, if indeed he has.
He has taken some shots, but I'm sure he's taken some shots along the way, because the Pac-10, for the most part, has been a very, very good conference. Yeah, that was on the interception. Rodney Pete threw the interception, and they got leveled by Frank Stams.
It was a peel-back block where they caught him flush. Frank Stams, not a small young man, 6'4", 240.
For the Irish, Ismail down at the 7. On the far side, you've got Anthony Johnson. On the near, you have, I believe it is Braxton Banks. The run-up and the kick, it'll come down. It'll come down to Braxton Banks, and he will take brings it back to the 15, gets it back to the 20, 25, 30, and up to about the 33-yard line. And you got to wonder why he just didn't hand the ball back to Ragib Ismail and said, "You carry, I'll lead." It's like a dance.
Probably the most secure thing he could have done is what he did.
Is there any kind of security when Southern Cal plays Notre Dame?
I don't think so.
Let's see if the Irish can move the ball. They have not been able to move the ball at all. I don't believe they got a first down in the second quarter. They did not. They have three for the game, all in the first quarter. Here's the Tony Rice making the ball to Braxton Bankton, pulling it out of the pit of his stomach and moving the ball upfield past the 35 up to about the 38 or 39 yard line. They'll mark it at the 38. So Tony Rice will pick up about almost 5 yards on the play. That's one of Notre Dame's better running plays on first down, Coach, in this game.
Tony Rice keeping the ball after a fake has been probably all year long their best weapon.
Mark Green is the tailback. The Irish go into a slot to the right. Rice is the quarterback. Faked it, nor did give it to Braxton Banks, and he's not going anywhere. Wound up in the winning arms again of Cordell Sweeney, the junior from San Jose, California. So now we've got a third down situation with a ball now at the 39-yard line, and we've got third down at about 5 yards or so to go. On third down conversions, the Irish were 2 of 6, while Southern California was 6 of 11.
It's funny how a team will have a path. The Irish haven't scored a whole lot in the third quarter of any of their games.
Irish goes slot right. Ragib Ismail, the wide out to the right side. Fake to the fullback on the option. Here's a pitch, a loose ball, scramble for it. Southern Cal has recovered. Nope, they say the ball went out of bounds. The ball was recovered by Carrier, but it was recovered out of bounds, and the Irish have just dodged a big, big bullet.
Well, that's the kind of thing that Southern Cal's defense was playing for. It was the triple option coming to the offensive left. Tony Rice was a little bit late with the pitch for -7. Could have been, as you say, a dangerous recovery by Southern Cal.
And when you look at the replay, the official made the correct call. Sexton, who shanked the last punt, 21 yards, gets the snap and punts the ball. Fires the ball upfield. Lockwood says they'll make the fair catch. No, let the ball bounce behind him, and the Irish are going to recover the ball and down it at about the 17-yard line. That's the second mistake he's made back there on a punt, a 51-yard punt. This is Notre Dame football on Mutual.
You can't protect your kids from all the life's bumps and bruises, but there are things you can do to make their lives safer. Accidents are the number one killer of kids. This year, 1 in 4 will be hurt badly enough to need medical attention. Surgeon General says most injuries can be prevented. Call the National Safe Kids Campaign at 1-800-365-KIDS for a free booklet on injury prevention and emergency response. 1-800-365-KIDS. Safe kids are no accident.
20-7, Notre Dame out in front. Southern Cal the ball, first down and 10 at about their 18. Tomorrow afternoon, the NFL on Mutual, 12:45 Eastern Time. Buffalo, Cincinnati, Joel Myers, Jack Ham. And then at 3:45, Jack Snow and I will be at the Mile High Stadium in Denver with the Rams and the Denver Broncos, two teams struggling to stay in the playoff picture. So big doubleheader, and of course that big one tomorrow. Buffalo with the best record in the National Football League and a shootout, Jim Kelly against the Boomer Esiason of the Buffalo Bills. Or the Cincinnati Bengals. Again, next Saturday, got to remind you about this one. One of America's great traditions. It'll be my 17th consecutive Army-Navy football game from Philadelphia. Airtime will be 1:40 Eastern Time. That's 1:40 next Saturday, Army and Navy. Rodney Pete is the quarterback. Bolt is the fullback. And it looks like Aaron Emanuel is the tailback. Double tight end, Frank Wright. Here's the toss, a bad toss, and Emanuel has to fall on the ball back at about the 10-yard line.
That pitch was to the eye back, and it happened to hit the fullback, who is the lead blocker, and Holter.
So Holt has the ball bounce off of him, but Emanuel pounces on the football. So the ball is at the 11-yard line, a loss on the play of about 7. It'll be second down, making it about 6, second down and 16 to go for a first down. Wide to the left goes John Jackson. Out to the right is Eric Affolder. Again, the eye tandem. Rodney Pete and his tight end Galbraith on the left side. Hands the ball off to Emanuel, and Emanuel breaks one tackle, but slides along the left side and finally gets down over the far side as the stop is made by the Irish. So it's going to be Arnold Ollie. He's a freshman out of Carson, California, who made the hit on the play. A gain of a couple up to the 13-yard line. It'll be third down and about, 13 yards to go for first. Now let's make it the 14-yard line, third down and 13.
It could very well be a rollout here because when he goes to the pocket, they have not picked up the blitz very well.
Affolder is wide to the left, Wellman out to the right. Straight drop back looking, throwing for Affolder on the far side. Pass is caught. Nice catch by Affolder at the 32-yard line on the first down.
Tony, you have to realize, I guess, if you're not seeing it, how perfect a throw that was, because Affolder had an inside-outside coverage by the corner and the safety man. The ball had to be perfectly thrown, and it certainly was.
So it was the first down at the 32. That's the fifth catch for Affolder. 18 yards on the reception. The last time Notre Dame and Southern Cal met, the Irish rushed for 351 yards and beating Southern Cal 26-15. Affolder, meanwhile, for the other side, Southern Cal, 8 catches, 102 yards that afternoon in South Bend. Here's the handoff. It's sweeping off the left side and getting up to about the 34-yard line. Jeff Brown, he's the number two fullback, his first carry. He's 5'10", a 210-pound senior from Balboa Island. He's usually one of the upbacks on the kickoff return team. They'll mark the ball close to the 35-yard line. Let's call it a gain of 3. It'll be second down and 7.
You know, I don't think the Southern Cal ever figured that they'd have so much difficulty running the ball. They've run it against some very good defenses in Oklahoma and UCLA, but they're having trouble eking out 3 points something per play on the rundowns.
28 carries, 82 yards for the Trojan running game. Slot right for Rodney Pete, hands it off to the tailback, Emmanuel, to the 40, to the 45, to the 50-yard line, and finally gets nailed at about the 48-yard line of Notre Dame. As Streeter and Terrell come up to make the tackle for the Irish, but a bull-like rush by Aaron Emmanuel and the junior from Palmdale, 17-yard burst up the middle, and the Trojans are in business.
One of the things that allowed Aaron Emmanuel to do that is the fact that it was playing a play off to the right, maybe off the right tackle, and he curled it all the way behind the pursuit, which is what the I-backs do so well.
John Jackson, flank to the right. Eric Affolder, wide to the left. The backs are split for Rodney Pete. Irish with 5 and up on the line of scrimmage. Here's Pete back to throw. Pump fake all kinds of time. Passes out to the near side, and the pass is incomplete. It was intended for running back Jeff Brown coming out of the backfield, and that's going to set up second down and 10. By the way, the last time when Rodney Pete faced the Irish at South Bend, he hit on 23 out of 45 for 275 yards.
He's a very poised young man when it comes to reading the defense, looking for an open receiver, buying time. He does it as well as any I've ever seen.
Second down. And 10 at the 48. Fumbled on the play, scramble for the football, and the Trojans have recovered. They recover the ball at the 50-yard line, and Aaron Emmanuel.
Rodney Pete pulling out from the snap. Happened to have the ball hit one of the pulling linemen. It happens on occasion, and that knocked the ball from his hands.
So now we've got third down, a loss of about a yard and a half. The ball at the 50-yard line. Third down and about 12 to go for the first down. Well, Weldon comes out to the right. Jackson goes out to the left. And you got the big receiver, Affolder, in a slot on the right side. Irish coming on a blitz. Rodney Pete from the shotgun. Here they come. Back to throw, steps up, fires the pass, the bullet near side. The catch is made by Wellman, and he is down at the 41-yard line. Not quite enough for the first down. His second catch of the afternoon, he is dragged down short of the first down by about two and a half yards. Now the question is, do they go for it, or do they try to put the Irish in a hole, and they send on the punting unit?
Well, it's a calculated thing. I think when you have a lot of time on the clock, you play it by the book. The book says if you want to bunt, punt it, pin them down, depend upon your defense, that's a smart play.
So now with fourth down coming up, and about 3 yards to go over the first, Spurl standing at the 44, three punts averaging 31 yards. A punt takes the low snap and gets the punt off. Puts the ball high, it'll come down, it'll bounce, it bounces at the 10, bounces inside the 10, down to the 5. The Irish are going to be pinned back down around the 2-yard line. Well, you sense a little deja vu here, maybe a bomb to rocket again.
I don't know.
38-yard punt.
I think twice fooled is twice bitten.
Timeout on the field, 27, the Irish out in front. Now this for Lionel Train.
The rock slide covered the track. As the train rounded the curve, disaster lay just ahead. Instinctively, your hand reached for the throttle, but someone else was already there.
Your dad. And he said that if you wanted to keep on playing and having a good time with your Lionel train, you'd want to slow down on the curve. Then you knew there was a time for fun and a time for responsibility. And you needed both of them for a train set and real life. Lionel Trains, a training ground for the future.
A look at the ball action coming up on Westwood One's radio networks on Mutual. The Eagle Aloha Bowl, Christmas Day, SeaWorld Holiday Bowl, the All-America Bowl, USF&G Sugar Bowl on the NBC radio network. It'll be the Liberty Bowl, the Fiesta Bowl, the Rose Bowl, the Orange Bowl. No question, the best bowl lineup is on Westwood One radio networks. No question about this either. The Irish find themselves right back where they were the very first time they got the ball in the first quarter. They were pinned back to their two. Right now, they're pinned back to their three. And they have not been able to move the football at all against a very stubborn Southern Cal defense.
And that's what you tell your defense here. You say, look, when you got them inside their own 10-yard line, you are on offense. You caused the turnover. You caused the fumble. That's how defense can get in the scoring column. The other thing is they, as you mentioned, on that first try from their own 2-yard line, threw the bomb. Southern Cal's got to be aware of that and will play a little looser than normal.
And the rocket goes out to the right side once again. Ismail out to the right. Tandem for Notre Dame. Here's a handoff to Green, and Green stumbled up to about the 5-yard line. Coming through to make the hit initially was Scott Ross, the sophomore linebacker from El Toro, California. He's the left inside linebacker, and he was not able to knock down Mark Green, who got a couple of yards to give Tony Rice a little breathing room. A couple, it'll be second down and 8. Aaron Robb comes out of the game. Myler's back in as flanker left. Ismail wide to the right. They'll be working against Ernest Spears on second down and 8. Here's Tony Rice. He's going to have to eat the ball. As Mark Green, who was supposed to be the recipient of the handoff, slipped and fell, and Tony Rice had no one to give the football to. So he'll lose back to the 1-yard line.
I was going to say he barely averted a safety.
And boy, they're not going to have much room if it comes time to punt, Coach Pagna. Tackle on that play made by Big Dan Owens. He's a junior from La Habra, California. Anthony Johnson comes out. Braxton Banks is back in. The rocket now wide to the left. Irish go high tandem. Let's see what Southern Cal does defensively. Tony Rice back to throw. Looks. And does he step out? What happened here?
I think a whistle stopped the play.
Yeah, there's a penalty marker down around the goal line. There's a penalty marker down around the goal line. The ref is going to be against the Irish. Half the distance of the goal line, half the distance of nothing is still nothing.
At best, could be the length of a football.
That's what it is. Well, the pressure is on, folks. The pressure is on Notre Dame.
Anthony Johnson coming in at fullback with a play. My guess it'll be something straightforward.
Straight to huddle. Rakib Ismail wide to the left. Myler's out to the right. High tandem. Will Southern Cal come on the blitz? Back to throw. Setting up. Throwing long. They're going for the rocket downfield. And he, did not make the catch. Down at the 47-yard line. Broken up by Chris Hale. Tony Rice sent a rainbow downfield. And the rocket almost made the grab.
Chris Hale, 5'9", 170, mirrors the rocket. He mirrored him foot step for step. Both of them have great speed, and he watched that ball all the way and went up for it to break up the play.
Now with fourth down, Sexton has approximately 10 yards. He's about 10 yards deep. Lockwood is up at the Notre Dame 44. Sexton takes the snap, gets the punt off. Spirals the ball upfield. Lockwood says he'll make the catch, and he does at the 43. Circles to the right, gets hit, gets nailed at the 42-yard line. There's also a penalty marker. There's another penalty marker on the play. A 42-yard punt and about a 1-yard return. The ball right now at the Irish 42-yard line.
They're talking to the Irish. It very well could be.
They're not talking to the Irish. Stonebreaker's in there kibitzing is what he's doing.
There is a difference.
No signal as yet. Flipping against. Well, what's the story here? Oh, they're going to talk now to Stonebreaker. Well, while they do that, we're going to tell you this is Notre Dame football on Mutual.
Now, Tidy Cat 3 is a hard-working cat box filler.
Tidy Cat 3, when you go, you go. It deodorizes better, absorbs like a real go-getter. Leaves no dust, no tracks around, Tidy Cat 3.
I'm Ed Lowe. My Tidy Cat 3 is 99% dust-free, so it's cleaner and healthier for your cat. And with my Tidy Cat 3 cat box finder, you may never have to wash your cat box again.
The ball at the 7 Cal 44-yard line now after a tipping call against the Trojans. And a reminder for our stations and our listeners across the nation, starting January 15th, major college basketball on Mutual, some great games lined up each Sunday afternoon. For example, Louisville, number 4, and number 13, Georgia Tech on the 15th of January. Number 2, Georgetown will take on number 12, Villanova on February 5th. They're among the great battles each Sunday. It all starts January 15th on Mutual. Well, it'll be first down and 10 at the 44-yard line of the Southern California Trojans. And again, the Irish unable to move the football, and they're going to call on their defense. And up to now, Coach, they have done a yeoman-like job.
Tony, it's one of the finest defensive teams that I've watched the Irish field in maybe 20 years. They just have the team speed, they have the size, the great team play. You can't single anybody out. Sometimes Frank Stams will make a great play, Jeff Alm, Zorich, George Streeter, any one of them makes a great play. Stan Smigala proved that.
John Jackson goes wide to the left. Southern Cal operating with a double tight end. Here's the play action fake. Rolling to the left is Rodney Pete. Fires the pass. Catch is made by Holt. Holt at the 50. Holt down to the 45. Stonebreaker makes the hit on Leroy Holt at the Irish 45-yard line. There's a penalty marker back at the Southern California 35. And I believe it was Frank Stams, who was boring in from the right side, was held on the play.
Run action pass. Frank had to be held out for a long time. And I think you're exactly right. They needed a little help. Grabbed him by the jersey.
It is 20-7. Notre Dame, 6:55 left to go in the third quarter of play. Southern Cal had the ball first down and 20 after the clipping call. Now it's first down and 20. As the ball is marched back to the 33-yard line. Somewhere along the way, they lost about a half a yard on that walk-off because it was closer to the 44. Now it's right on the 33. So
the receivers for Southern Cal, you're looking at 5'10", maybe 6 foot, 170, 185 pounders. They run precise patterns, nothing deep, not great speed people, but exacting patterns. Rodney Pete on the money.
Jackson, third catch. He's wide to the right. Wellman goes out to the left. Left, that is. F. Holder's in the slot. Mirko Jurkovic is in the game now for Notre Dame. And back to throw, Rodney Pete has the time, fires the pass, deflected away, and then deflected away, I believe, by Holt. Jeff Alm got a hand on it, then Holt got a hand on it and deflected the ball again. And so Jeff Alm gets credit for at least a partial PBU, pass broken up. And then Leroy Holt, the fullback from Southern Cal, did the rest. So that'll make it third down. And about 3.5 yards to go for a first down. The ball squarely on the midfield stripe. Hash mark near side. Notre Dame 20 and Southern Cal 7. 5 minutes and 50 seconds left to play here in the third quarter. Deployed to the right is Eric Affolder. Out to the left is John Jackson. Rodney Pete, the Irish coming on the blitz, a pass over the middle to Paul Green, and he is dragged down by the safety, George Streeter, and Green makes the catch, his third, and a first down at the Irish 45.
They were in man-to-man coverage. They blitzed the two inside linebackers. It got right on Pete. He unloaded it to a crossing tight end, which is a good unload. The crossing tight end, knowing where he's going, has a slight advantage. He's the leader being chased.
10th catch of the year for the tight end from Fresno, California, a 6'3", 230-pound senior. Rodney Pete, 18 out of 32 this afternoon, 183 yards, intercepted twice. Turns around, hands the ball off to his tailback, and coming off the right side is Ricky Irvins, and Irvins inside the 45, down to about, or was that Aaron Emanuel? One wears 34, that was Aaron Emanuel. He wears 24, got it down to the 42-yard line. Gain of a couple on the play. It'll be second down. Let's call it about 8 to go for a first down.
Southern Cal has not been able to move with any degree of consistency
on the
ground.
They've kept the ball so long, Coach.
Oh, yes.
31 carries. They've rushed for 100 yards.
It's their passing game that's kept them in it thus far.
Affolder is wide to the left. You got Jackson in the slot on the left side. Rodney Pete back to throw. Sets up, steps up in the pocket, gets hit, and gets knocked down by Jeff Alm at the 40-yard line. And now a penalty marker on the play. Penalty marker on the play. And it may be a face mask call against the Irish. After they keep Rodney Pete from going upfield, the Irish make a call for the face mask.
Jeff Alm credited him with some extra effort. It might be Jeff that's the guilty party in this, but at that, he came off of a block to save what was a long open field run for Rodney Pete if he should shake free.
So it'll be a short 5-yard walk-off. Down to the 35-yard line. 4:39 left to go in the third quarter.
That might have been a personal foul, Tony, because he seemed to be down, and I think they got him for filing.
No, they can't because it's only a 5-yard penalty. Had to be a face mask. Second down and a yard to go.
Inadvertent.
Okay. 8 out of 14 on third down conversion. But right now, Southern Cal, with Gary Wellman coming in, and now will become the wide receiver to the left. Rodney Pete seems to be a little confused, and Southern Cal may call for a timeout here, and that's what's going to happen. Pete going to the sideline, a timeout called. 20-7 is the score. Notre Dame's out in front. Now this for Sears.
To get your money's worth and more, and promise that we keep is right above the door.
Maybe a kitchen or bathroom remodeled? Trust your house with Sears, America's home improvement specialist.
Sears, your money's worth and a whole lot more.
3 a.m. I want a Twinkie. So dark. Aha! I found you. Mmm. Boy, there's strawberry in my Twinkie.
Discover new fruit and cream Twinkies with real strawberries swirled inside its creamy middle. Original Twinkies, too.
Gee, can a man eat in peace?
Ball is at the 35-yard line of Notre Dame. It is Southern Cal football, second down and about a half yard to go for a first down after the Irish get called for grabbing the face mask of Rodney Pete after he'd been dropped at the 40-yard line. So instead of facing third down and about seven or eight, or third down and seven, it is second down and just a half yard to go for a first down.
And in the strategic portion of the book, it says that this is a waste down, so it might be a run action pass.
Well, they line up with a double, they line up with a tight end to the left side. They got a slot man, Wellman, in motion now to the far side. Here's Rodney Pete on the handoff to Aaron Emanuel. Breaks one tackle, breaks another, gets to the 30, hit and knocked out at the 25-yard line. Excellent run by Aaron Emanuel, and a first down here for the Southern Cal Trojans at the Irish 25.
Aaron Emanuel made about three people miss on that to pick it up, really, and picked up the yardage on his own, pretty much.
The on-field dominance by Southern California. Four first downs to three for Notre Dame in the first quarter. The Irish have not had a first down since that time, while Southern Cal has 18 first downs. Right side is to the right. Slot to the right now for Rodney Pete. Half-holder is a wideout. Jackson in the slot. Here's the handoff to Aaron Emanuel. 20 down to the 15. He's at the 10, down to the 5, and it's first down and goal to go. George Streeter finally making the stop for Notre Dame. And the Irish defense, you have to wonder, are they beginning to wilt?
I'm sure that's a portion of it, Tony, but it's also psychologically a good call by the Trojans. They were on the left hash, they rolled out to the right, he slipped the ball to the tailback, it's a sprint off tackle, if you will, and the tailback found daylight because they were expanding for the rollout pass they thought.
And Aaron Emanuel, who came off the bench to have an outstanding game against UCLA a week ago, has carried the ball 16 times for 94 yards. Again the slot right, again the handoff to Emanuel, and Emanuel dropped this time at the 3-yard line. He ran right into the arms of Ned Volkar, who helped pick him up.
I'm not certain, Tony. It's so difficult to count bodies, but it seemed to me that they were unbalanced line that time to the wide side. They also had a slot. That only leaves you two blockers to the left of center, everybody else to the right.
2 minutes and 50 seconds left to play in the third quarter. Notre Dame nursing a 20-7 advantage. Again the I-10, and Emmanuel is the tailback. Rodney Peete pitching out to Aaron Emmanuel down to the 5. Pitching knocked down at the 4-yard line. He got hit by Wes Bridget, who leveled him. Just knocked him back at the 4-yard line. One of the best hits of the day.
One of the things, great support by the strong safety, George Streeter, and or rather the free safety, I'm sorry, because it was to the weak side they ran play. But I think what you're going to see here is something that gives him a two-way option, him being Rodney Peete. Left hash mark, look for a rollout to the right, buying time, trying to get his receivers free, lead with all the backs out of the backfield.
John Jackson goes wide to the left. Fifth play coming up in this drive. Now they've got a tackle as a tight end on the right side, and movement by number 62, Bill Marshall, the offensive right tackle. You can't miss him. He's 6'4", 305 pounds, a junior from Seat Pleasant, Maryland. Illegal procedure to call. That's going to set the Trojans back to the 9-yard line. Now, again, John Guerrero, who is offensive left tackle, moved on the right side and was lined up as the tight end on the right next to Marshall, who weighed 305. So you had Guerrero, who weighed 320, at the tight end spot.
They've got something in mind here with two tight ends and a flanker, maybe a crossing pattern.
Now a double tight end, a flanker left. And the flanker is Jackson, comes in motion across the field. Rodney Peete back to throw, sets, fires the pass. Far-sided is incomplete. It's better for Galbraith, the tight end. And now it is fourth down and 9 yards to go. Fourth and 9, and the field goal unit comes onto the field. First field goal try in this game. And right now, it'll be Quinn Rodriguez to try the field goal. 13 out of 18 on the year. The longest, a 47-yarder. He is a left-footed soccer-style kicker. This will be a 26-yard field goal attempt. 26-yard field goal attempt. Spot down. The kick is up. He hooks it. What was it? It was good. He hooked it through. It is good. And that's going to cut the margin now. Notre Dame 20 and Southern California 10 with 1 minute and 38 seconds left to play here in the third quarter. So the Irish holding on. Only 3 first downs, all coming in the first quarter of play.
A minute 38 seconds left in the third quarter gives them plenty of time, and I think other than the time that they had on the clock, they would not have chosen to go for the field goal attempt.
We're going to pause briefly here for station identification. This is Mutual, your network leader in radio sports.
You are listening to AM 1130 WNEW, New York.
Tony Roberts along with Tom Pagna. And a crowd of well over 90,000 at Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum. There is not a seat to be had here for this game between two unbeaten, untied teams. And the disparity in the vote margin, Notre Dame has 8 more points than Southern Cal in the AP college football ranking. Well, they have yet to kick the ball to the Rocket. He's standing down at the 6-yard line, and the Irish need another big play from somebody because Southern Cal has continued to dominate. Here's the kick. It'll be soft. It'll be high. It'll come down, and it goes out of bounds. It went out of bounds somewhere in the vicinity of the 24-yard line. So the penalty marker is thrown.
It is the obvious attempt to kick away from the Rocket, Tony. I think it causes that. He tried to diagonal the ball and have one of the upbacks pick it up around the 25 or 30. They're willing to give that much away in order to keep it out of Ismail's hands.
Sixth penalty against Southern Cal, 51 yards in total penalty. The Irish have 4 for a total of 32.
The kicker just talked to Coach Larry Smith. Got some kind of final instruction. I kind of think he'll squib it. That is, kick it powerfully, but on the grounder.
On the far side, you've got Anthony Johnson. On the near, you've got another fullback. You've got Braxton Banks. And the upback for the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, that'll be Don Grimm, a linebacker. He's standing at the 31-yard line. And in all probability, if they do that, why, they'll kick it to him. Now, you have Ballas up here around the 39-yard line, and he's able to run the football.
Yes, there's several of them that are, that's their hands team, I'm sure.
But you would think that he would be back a little, either down the middle, Where if they do kick the ball short, you'd have at least a viable running back, unless Don Grimm has got some kind of secret weapon that we haven't seen. All right, here's the kick. It'll end over end. It'll come down, and the Rocket says a gravity does it to the 11, to the 15, to the 20, to the 25, and gets nailed at about the 29 or 30 yard line. Good hit on the play by Southern Cal, and it was made by the Trojans, Matt T. He's out of Arkansas City, Kansas. He's a 6'3", 230-pound freshman linebacker who plays on the special team. So the Irish have the ball first down and 10 at the 30. And Tom Packett, they've got to get some first down. They've got to give that defense a rest.
It's usually Mark Green that pulls them out of the doldrums with some kind of a straight-ahead blast. And that's what they haven't had any success with.
Now, big split up the middle by the Trojan defense. Here's Tony Rice rolling out to the right. Rice now 30, outside, 35 at the 40, and knocked out at about the 42-yard line. And Tony Rice has just rambled for about 13 yards, and Notre Dame's first down since the first quarter of play.
And that rollout was a pure and simple run all the way. The wide receivers were blocking. One of the things that Tony Rice has is very deceptive speed. When he got out deep enough to get outside of contain, he can turn it on.
13-yard romp around the right side by Rice. The ball at the 43-yard line. 20-10, Notre Dame. Weenie moments of the third quarter. Rice, the quarterback. Slot to the left. Hands it off to Green. Green finds the going rough. Not much there for Mark Green. Again, moving in with Scott Ross to kind of plug it up. And the rest of the Southern Cal defense got the job done as Green is able to get only 2 yards. And on too many times this afternoon, we have seen that Notre Dame giving the ball to Mark Green and getting only 2 yards on first down, which sets up second down and long.
They're playing a little conservatively now. They don't want to go to the option and place the ball on the ground. They don't want to throw it if they don't have to, but they might do either of those things.
Robin a slot to the left. Ismail the wideout. Fake. Here's Tony Rice carrying the ball to the 50, and he is tripped up as he got to about the 49-yard line. And again, the tackle made by Don Gibson, the 6'3", 250-pound sophomore nose guard out of Orange, California. Tony Rice stumbling down at the 50-yard line. Will be short of a first down by almost 3 yards. Let's call it about 2.5 to go. So a big third down play for the Irish. And Coach Lou Holtz sends that play in with Pat Eilers. And on third down conversion, the Irish only 2 of 8 on the afternoon. They will not get a playoff at the end of the third quarter with a score. Notre Dame 20, Southern Cal 10. Now this for the Discover Card.
The holidays. It's a time of traditions. Traditionally, you spend money giving gifts.
Hey, just what I wanted.
Entertaining friends. And festively decking the halls. Now you can get some of that money back. Just choose the Discover Card, the card that pays you cash back for every charge, up to 1% back every year based on your annual purchases. Money back every year from the Discover Card. Now there's a great tradition. It pays to discover the card that pays you back.
Nibble, nibble, pick, pick, head and stomach feeling sick. Spicy meatballs, pepperoni, enchilada, and bologna, burning belly, about to burst. Chocolate, mother, liverwurst, cause the service what you need. Do the rest, you worse than me.
When your stomach and head can't take any more, send for the bubble without the filter, cause lean is what you need.
Nibble, nibble, pick, pick, I'm the stuff that works quick. They can find the rich and nurse, wonder why your stomach hurts. Nibble, nibble, for the trouble, summer, I'll become the bubble, pick, pick. Now you need the one to rescue you and me.
Alka-Seltzer to the rescue.
Use only as directed.
The numbers after 3. Irish 4 first downs, 112 yards to the ground, 68 passing, 180 total. 7 Cal, 19 first downs, 133 rushing, 183 passing, 316 total. Rice 4 out of 8, not intercepted. Rodney Pete 18 out of 33, picked off twice. Notre Dame's lost the ball once in a fumble. 7 Cal coughed it up twice on the fumble. 4 penalties for the Irish, 6 for 7 Cal. Notre Dame only 32 offensive plays. 69 for Southern California. Notre Dame has 180 total yards. 120 came in 2 big plays. Tony Rice's 65-yard touchdown run and Rice's 55-yard pass to the Rocket Ismail on the first play of the game for the Irish. And if you look at the third down conversion, Notre Dame, as we said, 2 of 8. They came into the game. They're well below right now their season average of 50%. But Southern California, 9 of 15, that's 60%. They're 1 percentage point above what they normally do in a game, 59%.
we're looking, or we're going to look at, a third down that's very crucial at the beginning of the fourth quarter. It's crucial for the Irish to maintain possession and eat up some time on the clock. It's crucial for Southern Cal because they need the field position and to force the punt.
The ball at the midfield stripe, hash mark far side. Notre Dame 20 and Southern California 10. The fourth quarter about to unfold. Wide to the right, the Rocket. In a slot to the right, Pat Eilers. Anthony Johnson is the fullback. Third down, 2.5. Hand off to Johnson. Johnson sneaks his way. First down to the 40-yard line of Southern California. And the Irish have two consecutive first downs.
They had the tight end, the line to the left, and a slot to the right. It was just what they call a belly-off tackle out of the fullback slot to the left. And he just read daylight and buried himself, really, about 2 feet off from the ground, parallel to the ground, and the body leaned.
The 225-pound junior fullback from South Bend gives the Irish a first at the 40-yard line. Rice with Aaron Robb now at the flanker right. Ismail wide out to the left side. Long count. Hands it off to Mark Green. Green hit and stumbled. Gets inside the 40 down to about the 39-yard line. Making contact the nose guard Don Gibson for Southern Cal. No gain on the play at the 40-yard line. It'll be second down and 10 for the Irish.
The Southern Cal defensive line is doing something I haven't seen any team do all season long against the Irish, and it is making penetration, getting into the other zone and causing some trouble with the running backs.
Again, the slot to the right. Eilers in the slot, Ismail the wideout. Johnson the fullback, Green the tailback. On the option, here's Tony Rice at the 40. Tony Rice now to about the 36-yard line. As he is dropped from behind, the hit made by Scott Ross. And now it is going to be third down. And a big third down it is once again. Third down with about 6 yards to go for a first down. The Irish have to get the ball just inside the 30-yard line to come up with another first down. Into the game, Aaron Robb. Will the Irish put the ball in the air?
Well, their favorite play in this circumstance was to roll out to the wide side with Tony Rice, making it look like pass, but it winds up being a run. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if he didn't do it here.
Wide side of the field is to the left. Eilers in the slot, back to throw, looking right, swings the ball out to the near side, pass caught, Johnson, 30, Johnson 25, Johnson down to the 20, Johnson to the 15, he to the 13, and it is first down for Notre Dame.
A perfectly executed screen play. He had a slot to the left, tight end to the right, tight end drove off, the fullback wound his way all the way from the left guard, slid all the way back through the screen. Tony Rice was a good actor. He kept his vision left, then wheeled and threw the ball to Anthony Johnson, who picked up 23 yards on a total play, run and pass.
So it is first down for the Irish at the Southern California 13-yard line. High tandem, double tight end, flanker to the left side. Tony Rice waiting for the snap from Held, gives it to Johnson. Johnson down to the 10. Johnson down to about the 8-yard line before he gets stopped. Mark Terrier on the stop along with Tracy Butts, the senior out of Riverside, California. So a good surge up the middle by the Irish fullback, who hasn't been used very much this afternoon. And it'll be a pickup on the play of about 4, make it second down and 6 yards to go for a first down.
20-10, a score here might ice the thing for the Irish. Very crucial drive.
Now you got to remember what happened a couple of years ago, Tom. Green the tailback. Here's the option run by Rice at the 10, down to the 5, to the goal line. Very close. He's not quite in. He's down at the 1-foot line. Tony Rice, option right, and the ball just shy of the goal line. Another step and he's in. Just 7th first down of the game, and the third in this fourth quarter by the Irish.
Again, it was that option play where he sticks the ball in the gut of the fullback, rides him into the line, then pulls it out and keeps it.
11 carries, 96 yards for Tony Rice. Wishbone backfield, double tight end for Notre Dame. Rice the quarterback. Turns around, gives that ball, and diving into the end zone. Touchdown, Mark Green. Mark Green, who is from Riverside, California, with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Irish open the fourth quarter with a drive that took them some 70 yards for a score on 10 plays. And Mark Green goes in from the one, and Notre Dame now leads it 26-10.
And as they've so often done in short yardage situations, they come to a two tight end offense, a full house backfield, a wishbone backfield. They lead with a fullback and a halfback. and give it to the off halfback. In that case, the left halfback, Mark Green, was the ball carrier. Braxton Banks, the lead blocker.
Reggie Hall for the point after spot down. The kick is up in the air, and it is good. And now it is a 17-point Notre Dame lead. 27-10 timeout. Now this for Tidy Cat.
Now Tidy Cat 3 is a hard-working cat box filler.
Tidy Cat 3, when you go, you go. It deodorizes better. Absorbs like a real go-getter. Leaves no dust, no tracks around. Tidy Cat 3.
I'm Ed Lowe. My Tidy Cat 3 is 99% dust-free, so it's cleaner and healthier for your cat. And with my Tidy Cat 3 cat box finder, you may never have to wash your cat box again.
It is Notre Dame 27, Southern California 10, but a lot of time left. 11:55 to go. On the Sears scoreboard this afternoon, final, Georgia 24, Georgia Tech 3. Another final, Mississippi State lost to Mississippi 33-6. Final, Tennessee 14 and Vanderbilt 7. Final, Houston 45, Rice 14. Another final, Miami of Florida with a field goal late, 18-16 over Arkansas. Final, 32-28, Tulsa beating Colorado State. And final, Temple 45, Boston College 28. That's the Sears scoreboard. Sears, where you get your money's worth and a whole lot more. Seven to ten. And I just say caution, Tom Packner, because we saw what a 17-point lead the Southern Cal had a couple of years ago against the Irish here. What happened to it in the last 12 minutes of play?
Oh, I'd be the last one to deny the possibility, Tony. I'm just being practical from what I'm seeing. The Irish have really played some tough defense. It would be a small miracle for the Southern Cal team to have to score now three times, whether it's a combination of three touchdowns or two touchdowns and a field goal.
Irvin's on the near side. You got Calvin Holmes, a freshman out of Carson, California, in the middle. And Lockwood, Scott Lockwood, the tailback over on the far side at the five-yard line. 10-play drive, 70 yards, and the kick will go down to the far side, and it will go out of bounds, and that's exactly what the Irish didn't want to happen.
Well, that puts you back five. He's a short kicker anyhow, so I think the next ball can be fielded somewhere around the 15 or 20-yard line. Any kind of a return gets him close to midfield.
Well, the kicking game for Notre Dame has really been a bugaboo, so to speak, and especially in the last half of the season.
Lou Holtz said all year long that there are three phases, offense, defense, and the kicking game, and he stressed defense. He really had a defense this year. They played well up to this point, and I see no reason that they'll change it.
Well, a legal procedure to call against the Irish, but of course the ball to be moved back to the 30-yard line. And the one thing you can't afford to do is give Rodney Pete in Southern California any kind of field position. And it looks like that's exactly what Notre Dame is going to do. Now they are doing something to Tony Rice on the sideline. Looks like he's being wrapped up a little bit.
Looks to me like they're taping him. He might have had a small or a slight hip pointer.
Here's a run-up and the kick. It'll go high. It'll come down. It'll be taken by Holmes at the 13, 15, 20. Gets to the outside at the 25. Gets to the 30, 35, to the 40-yard line. And out of bounds at around the 41-yard line. So it'll be first down and 10 for Southern California. They've got the ball in excellent field position. Juan Francisco finally made the stop on the play. But they allowed Calvin Holmes to get to the outside, and he has given them the ball first down and 10 at the Southern Cal 40-yard line.
And you know, because of time dictating it, that the air is going to be full of footballs, and it's a question of whether to rush Rodney Pete or try to bend, don't break.
Oh, no. Go for him. Go for him. No, I don't believe. Hey, we got the three quarters. We got the three quarters, Coach.
I just gave you the alternatives.
Well, I don't want that alternative. High tandem slot left. Rodney Pete, the quarterback. Frank Stamps prime to move across the line of scrimmage. Back to throw, Pete looking, fires the ball over the middle. The pass deflected and almost intercepted. Pass was deflected by Chris Sorich. And then almost got picked off as Pete tried a soft pass over the middle. You know, I don't believe in pre-bet. I really don't. You know, I argue with my partner on Sunday, Jack Ham, about playing pre-bet. This is what got Notre Dame here. Rushing, they haven't stopped Rodney Pete, but they've contained him somewhat. Now he'll operate from the shotgun. You let him stand back there and throw all day, he's going to pick us apart. Back to throw is Pete looking, fire. No, never got the pass off. big rush by Frank Sams from the left side. Boy, these are the kind of games that make you an All-America. You know, when you have a game like Frank Sams is having.
Frank Sams has proven that he's a key clutch player in all the big plays, all the big games this year. He's been there, Johnny on the spot.
Second sack of the Irish for the Irish this afternoon. It is third down and 19 to go now. A loss of 9 on the play. And again, Rodney Pete from the shotgun back at his 25. Back to the 20. He loses Frank Sams, but then runs into another Irish defender who nails him. Nope, he didn't. He got the pass off. And then a hit is made up around the 42-yard line.
That very well might have been a lateral. He felt himself being caught from behind and going down. The receiver that he lateraled it off to,
Scott Lockwood,
was in trail of him.
So with fourth down coming up, they picked up about 10 yards on that play. They still have 9 to go. It'll be punting time for Chris Burrell and Southern California. Nice play. Rodney Pete is such great, great ability. And then a tremendous hit made out there by Wes Pritchett. Wes Pritchett's mom, Elise, has got to be, she's got to be sky high the way her son has played here this afternoon. Here's the chest high snap and the punt. End over ender will bounce down at the 30, at the 20. Well, Eiler's going to let the ball roll, get away from it. Okay, down to the 22-yard line, and it'll be first down and 10 at that spot. It is 27-10, Irish. This is Notre Dame football on Mutual.
Hi, Mr. Keebler.
You're cheerleaders.
Cheer, cheer for all.
You don't sound cheery.
It's our tortilla chips.
A little heavy.
Try our light and crispy Sancheros.
Sancheros?
Tortilla chips made by Pequeños Quibleros. Elfin cousins from the southwestern branch of the tree.
Let's hear it for Sancheros.
Sancheros, Sancheros. Yay!
I fear for the opposition.
Tony Roberts along with Tom Pagnin and a multitude of thousands at Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum, where the Irish are out in front by a score of 27-10. But there are 10 minutes and 13 seconds left to play. Notre Dame has the ball, first down and 10 at his 22-yard line. And Tony Rice will come to the sideline to talk to his coach, Lou Holtz. Rodney Pete has been outstanding this afternoon for Southern Cal. And the Trojan defense has been outstanding. And for most of the game, they have stifled the Irish offense. 18 out of 34, 183 yards, and intercepted twice. Those are the Rodney Pete numbers this afternoon. Irish go to the wishbone, off the left side, diving through, and snaking a pass to 25. I think he stepped on a couple of backs to get up to the 27-yard line. Mark Green for Notre Dame, the left halfback in a wishbone formation.
That's an isolation play again where you're blocking with a guard tackle and tight end to the side, leading the fullback and the right halfback, giving it to the left halfback.
Aaron Robb into the game along with Anthony Johnson. Robb becomes a wide receiver out to the left. And with the exception of Rocket Ishmael, Notre Dame really does not have a pass-catching threat, Coach. High tandem. Tony Rice on second down. Hands it off to Green. Green dancing through. Fights his way. Gets up to about the 31-yard line. And just about a yard short of a first down. The attendance this afternoon, 93,829. Largest crowd for a Southern Cal Notre Dame game at the Coliseum in 33 years.
I don't see a body out there moving to make a move towards an exit either.
It is the ninth largest crowd for a Notre Dame Southern Cal game. Third down, and about a yard to go for a first down. Robb is wide to the left. Green the tailback. Braxton Banks the fullback. Hands off to Banks. Got the first down to the 40. Make that to the 36-yard line. As Braxton Banks came off the right side. And all of a sudden, Tom Pagna, it seems that Notre Dame is able to do things that they have not been able to do, weren't able to do most of the first quarter when they got three first downs, all of the second quarter, and all of the third quarter.
No question about it, Tony. I think they sense it. And when you do, you just get new, renewed strength.
And more important, perhaps, the fact that the defense is getting a breather and a well-deserved one.
Yes.
First down and 10 at the 36. Flanker left, wishbone backfield. Tony Rice going to get nailed. Boy, they snuffed that one out. There was no doubt about that. As Craig Hartsiker, he is a linebacker on the right side, came barreling through from Valley Center, California, and dropped Tony Rice for a big loss back to the 30-yard line. And that's going to shut up second down and 17.
That was a calculated risk. They had the full house backfield, and they've run that play over and over, give it to the left half, lead with the fullback in the right half. Only Tony didn't make the handoff. He bootlegged it, and they were wise to it.
Second and 17 for the Irish. Tony Rice on a handoff to Green, and Green runs into a couple of red-shirted Trojans. Green stopped at about the 28-yard line after getting nailed by Tim Ryan and company. Only four Notre Dame players have rushed the ball today. Rice, 12 carries, 89 yards. Green, 15 for 24. Johnson, 6 for 27. Braxton Banks has carried twice for 6. So now the Irish with third down and 17, no gain on the play. The ball at the 29-yard line. But the clock continues to wind down. It shows 7 minutes and 20 seconds remaining. Flanker left, Rob. Wide out right, Ishmael. Toss to the left side, Green. Green to the 30, 35. He's at the 40. He's up to the 42-yard line. Mark Green looked like he might break it for the first down. Got it up to the 42-yard line, and it's going to be fourth down. Still a little shy of the first down. Junior Soul finally made the tackle for Southern California. And with fourth down coming up, the ball is going to be marked at the 40-yard line. And so it'll fourth down coming up. The Irish are going to punt the football. 6:40. And the clock continues to wind. And that's why Notre Dame has not thrown the football. They want the time to expire as much as possible. Down at the 15-yard line. Looking up into the sun, by the way, is Scott Lockwood. Sexton with his back to the sun at the 28. High snap, rush on, penalty marker on the play, and I believe there's going to be a 5-yard penalty against the Irish. There may be a delay of game call. That was scary because that was either going to be a block punt or a sack right there.
Bill Sexton did a great job of just retrieving the snap. The snap was so high over his head, he left the ground with both feet reaching up and making a grab of it. You're right, though, it was going to be blocked.
So now Lockwood moves up to the 20-yard line. And Sexton moves back to his own 22. 6:25 showing. Southern Cal, 19 first downs, only 8 for the Irish. None in the second, none in the third quarters. But Notre Dame leads at 27-10. There's the knee-high snap and the punt. Got it off. End over end. Bounces 30, under the 25, inside the 20. It continues to roll, and the Irish will down it at the 18-yard line of field goal. 48-yard punt. I'll tell you, that would never win the pass, punt, and kick contest, but he got the most out of it. Timeout with a score, 27-10 Irish. This is Notre Dame football on Mutual.
Catch the excitement of NFL doubleheader action each Sunday on Mutual.
55-second plus on third down at 11. The throws, that look going down the right side, and then over Jerry Rice makes the catch. 40, 30, 20, 10. The Giants are going to be trailing as Jerry Rice catches a touchdown pass from Joe Montana of 78 yards.
Join Tony Roberts, Hall of Famer Jack Ham, Joe Myers, and Jack Snow as they bring you the best in the NFL.
They go with that double tight end set again. Ellard over to the right side, the single wideout. There's split in the backfield. Ellard in motion to the near side. McTyre is staying with him all the way in motion. And Everett joined back to pass. Pat McGee, the flat wide open to the five. Dives in. Is he in? Yes. Touchdown Rams.
The top two games each week come your way.
The deep back is Kevin Mack. Ernest Potter's also in the backfield. Double tight end. Man in motion to the right side. Hand off to Mack. Mack off the right side. Pulls his way. Touchdown.
The NFL each Sunday on Mutual.
Notre Dame 27, Southern Cal 10. 6 minutes and 7 seconds left to play in the contest. The ball is at the 18-yard line of the Trojans. And the Irish defense really got a nice little respite the last couple of times the offense had the football.
Defense, the first half, was only on the field 20 minutes as opposed to Southern Cal's 10. Second half has been a different story.
Half holder is wide to the left. Rodney Peake back to throw. Looking, under pressure. Gets in, he's back at a 10-yard line. And the big rush is on. And again, it looked like it might have been Frank Stanton, and that's who it was. Number 30, third time that Peake has been sacked this afternoon. A loss on the play of 8. It'll be second down and 18.
And Southern Cal went to the hustle huddle. They didn't go to a huddle. They just lined up and shotgun again.
Second down and 18 from the 5-yard line. Pete on the inside, handoff to Leroy Holt. And Holt fights his way up to about the 15-yard line. Got about 5 yards on the play before getting stopped. Mirko Jurkovic is in there now for Notre Dame. And now with third down, and some of the Southern Cal fans starting to boo. They didn't like that call at all. Pete from the shotgun, slot left, got a wide out to the right, has the time to throw, fires a pass. The pass is incomplete. And of all people that dropped the ball, it was right in his hand, was the All-America receiver, Affolder. But you know what? He took a pop out there, I believe, from Darrell Flash Gordon. That's who it was. And with fourth down coming up, and you can hear the Irish fans who are below us here at Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum, they are on their feet to a man, waiting and cheering. 5:11 left to go in the game. And Spurl, back to punt, standing at the 1-yard line. Nobody back for Notre Dame. The Irish don't believe he's going to punt the ball, and if he does, so what? Here's the snap, and the punt by Spurl. Gets the spiral upfield. It'll hit, and at the 40, inside the 35, inside the 30, and it'll be down at the 29-yard line of Notre Dame. And the Irish will have the ball after a 56-yard punt with a score 27-10 Notre Dame. Timeout. Now this for True Value Hardware.
Hi, folks. Hey, this is your all-weather friend, Woodard Scott, for True Value Hardware, your store of first choice. When you hear everyone singing I'll Be Home for Christmas, it's time to get ready for guests. Warm up your crowd with a Bun Pour-O-Matic coffee brewer, just $39.99. And for heavy-duty mixing, the KitchenAid Ultra Power Stand Mixer packs 300 watts of power with 10 speeds and handy accessories. You'll find it at participating True Value Hardware stores and home centers. Della Willard Scott sent you.
You look and look again. It's a totally new automobile, yet you know what it is. You've never seen it, but you recognize it immediately. The classic lines, the distinctive shape. Contemporary as a car can be, yet it recalls a grand tradition. It's obviously the Riviera, the 1989 Buick Riviera. It's a classic all over again.
Notre Dame, 5 minutes away from a quantum leap toward getting the inside track on the national championship. The Irish 27, Southern California 10. 5 minutes left to go in the contest. Notre Dame owns the football. First down and 10 at the 29-yard line.
I think we're watching a little piece of history here today, Tony. No question about it, with 11 games.
Irish will go double tight end. Jacobs left and Derek Brown right. Braxton Banks the fullback. Mark Green, the tailback, takes the toss, sweeps to the left, to the 30, spins up to the 35-yard line. He'll pick up 6 yards on the play. It'll be second down at about 3. Chris Hale, the quarterback, the senior from Monrovia, California, came up to make the stop. So Notre Dame going to the power formation, the double tight end, with a sweep by Green off the left side, gets 6. Aaron Robb in the game and Ivers out. In case you happen to tune in late, Ricky Waters and Tony Brooks, because of habitual tardiness for team meeting, were sent home this morning to South Bend, Indiana. So the Irish missing two of their key cogs. Here's the handoff to Braxton Banks. He's not going anywhere. Matter of fact, he's going to lose a yard or so back to the 34-yard line. The swarming Southern Cal defense making the stop. But the time continues to wind down. And now that tool becomes the enemy of the Trojans, whose aspirations to be number one and to claim the national championship are beginning to fade. 3 minutes, 50 seconds left to go in the game. It is third down and 5 for Notre Dame, with a ball at the Irish 34-yard line. Otters goes wide to the left. Steve Allenby will split out to the right. Johnson, the fullback, Tony Rice on the quarterback draw. Well, it either was supposed to be a handoff to somebody, or Tony Rice, it looked like a busted play to me, trying to run it up the middle, and he stopped at the 31-yard line, and that's going to set up fourth down at about 8 yards to go, and Sexton will have to come in to punt. But the seconds continue to tick away. 3 minutes, 15 seconds left to go. Lockwood standing at the 35-yard line, 34, make it the 33. Back down to the 30-yard line. Now looking up into the sun. In my estimation, Tom Pagna, he is much too deep and out of the range of Jim Sexton's punting ability.
Yes, he is, and he's also, he placed himself in the sun and probably will not feel it. He hasn't yet.
And now we've got time. There's going to be a delay of game call, I believe, against the Irish. The clock now under 3 minutes. 2:53 remaining.
When they analyze the statistics of this game, they're going to have to find out or realize that beyond statistics are turnovers.
Might have been worth the 5 seconds to keep him about 10 yards deeper into the sun.
Might have been
worth the 5 yards. Standing at the 13, Sexton, chest high snap. And what happens here? Before he can punt the ball,
does Notre Dame have too many men on the field? 4, 8.
Oh, come on.
No. At 11.
Illegal procedure. Well, if they keep this up, they'll be punting from their end zone.
And Lockwood just moved from the sun to the shade. They're awful close to it.
Certainly did. All right, they're going to try it again. Third time may be the charm, Coach. Now Sexton back at the 8-yard line. Helmet high snap and gets the punt off. Nice spiral by Sexton. Lockwood under it at the 33. 35. Gets up to the 40. Breaks the tackle. Spins to the 45. And is down at the 48-yard line. It'll be first down and 10 for Southern Cal. 46-yard punt. 15-yard return. And the Trojans have the ball first and 10 at their own 48-yard line.
Only 2 minutes and 41 seconds left in this game. The 11th game could be the 11th. Consecutive win this season.
First and 10 for the Trojans. Out to the right goes Wellman. Out to the left is Jackson.
From the shotgun, Rodney Pete takes the snap. It's low. Drops back to throw. Fires to the right side. The pass is caught. It is Wellman to the 40, down to the 35, hit and knocked down at about the 28-yard line or 33-yard line. It was Darrell Flash Gordon who made the stop on the play, 19 yards on the play.
A hustle huddle again by the Trojans, lining right up on the ball. They're into their two-minute drill.
27-10 Notre Dame. Rodney Pete from the shotgun once again. Slot right, wide out left. Back to throw. Fires the pass to the near side. The pass is incomplete. They cut it for John Jackson. Rodney Pete, 19 out of 37, 202 yards on the afternoon. His high this year, 22 out of 29, 305 yards, 3 touchdowns, intercepted one time. His low, 16 out of 20, 286 yards, 1 touchdown. No intercepts from the shotgun again. Pete under pressure, fires a pass near side. Ball is caught and knocked down immediately at about the 27-yard line with Scott Lockwood, who came out of the backfield. Not enough for the first down. A gain on the play of maybe about 5 yards. That will set up third down at about 5 to go. Lockwood was not able to get out of bounds. Thus, the clock is now at 2 minutes. 2 minutes left to go. Pete looking, back to throw, under pressure by Frank Stamp, throws the ball up in the air, and it's going to be almost intercepted. Todd Light almost picked it off, and then racing over to try to pick it off was Courtney Southall inside the 10-yard line. That would have been the Trojans' last hurrah.
Oh, I think they're close to it anyhow, Tony. I really do. It would take more than a minor miracle with a minute and 49 seconds, but you never count it until it's in the bag.
Whether you're with Notre Dame or against Notre Dame, there's always the possibility of a miracle.
I would hope that was true.
The ball at the 28, a minute 49 to go. It'll be fourth down and 5. This could be the last hurrah for the Trojans. Pete back to throw, set, look, fires a bullet up the middle. It is a first down at the 15-yard line as Jackson makes the catch and Courtney Southall makes the hit. His fourth catch of the afternoon, and the Trojans are still alive. 1:41 to go. Notre Dame with 3 timeouts remaining. Southern Cal has 2 left. Rodney Pete from the shotgun. From the 15, drops back to the 25, sets and fires. The pass near side is caught by Ricky Irvin, and the sophomore from Pasadena, California, is nailed at the 13-yard line. The clock continues to wind down. Irvin's not able to get out of bounds. At the 13, it'll be second down and about 7 to go.
Rodney Pete chipping away. Back to throw. Set. Looks. Runs on the right. Throw the pass. Quick by. His running back coming out of the backfield and nailed immediately was Jeff Brown at the 10-yard line. And now a little extracurricular shoving and pushing out there. But the play is going to be dead at the 10. It'll be a gain on the play. It'll go up three. And that will set up third down at about 5 yards to go for a Southern Cal first down. Meanwhile, the clock shows 61 seconds left to play. 61 left, and Rodney Pete has gone to the sideline after calling a timeout to talk to Coach Larry Smith and the Southern Cal Brain Trust. Rodney Pete is facing a four-man rush. The Irish are content to do that. They can put some pressure on him with four men. They can zone or double cover the wideouts with the remainder of the seven men, and that's what they've chosen to do on this drive. Now, what's going to come up, as sure as tomorrow is Sunday, whose picture was on the cover of Sports Illustrated this week?
I don't know.
Rodney Pete.
You think the jinx, huh?
The jinx. The jinx will resurrect itself as sure as tomorrow is Sunday. But the Irish defense had a little something to do with that.
Yes, I think so. More so than superstition.
And you can't say Rodney Pete had the kind of game that a lot of quarterbacks would like to have.
I think he's outstanding, Tony.
Yes, he is.
He's a viable, still alive in the Heisman race, an outstanding collegiate quarterback in a losing cause, I think, today. But 23 out of 42, not his best day for 225 yards, but certainly an outstanding day.
But two big interceptions by the Irish defense.
Yes, that and the two fumbles, I think, cooked the goose of the Trojans today.
Thanksgiving's over, Coach. Down to the 10. Third down and 5. Southern Cal at the Irish 10-yard line. Notre Dame looking at Southern Cal's offense, slot left. Play action fake. Peek back to throw. Fires a pass near side, and it is incomplete. Intended for John Jackson, who got a little bit of a shove, just to let you know I'm in the vicinity, from safety George Streeter.
The Irish that time crossed him up a little bit because they did have an inside blitz on with both linebackers. Went to man-to-man coverage. We probably are going to see a repeat of that same thing this down. It's fourth and maybe 5 to go for the first down. Fourth and 10 for the touchdown.
Less than a minute remaining. 57 seconds to play. Fourth down and 5 to go. Southern Cal with a ball at the 10-yard line of Notre Dame. The Irish in front 27-10. Rodney P. high snap. Looking from the shotgun, fired the pass, it is knocked down. Batted down off the body of George Streeter. Was intended for Eric F. Holder. Rodney Pete took a hit, went down. The last hurrah for the Southern California Trojans.
This is a big, big victory out here for the Irish.
And I have been privileged twice to do a game where Lou Holtz sent two outstanding offensive players home because of team rule infraction, and they won both games. Knocked off Oklahoma and Billy Sims in the Orange Bowl and beat number 2 Southern Cal at the Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum.
Well, I think a mark of a great coach, and certainly Lou is that you are consistent and you do what you say you will do for all members of your squad at any time.
Frank Graham, is that Frank Graham? Hands the ball off, and we've got Frank Graham at quarterback. We got a lot of clean jerseys in there now, as Lou Holtz sending a lot of people in there. And I believe that was Steve Bellis who made the carry. Kent Graham, Steve Bellis makes the carry. Steve, of course, is a backup quarterback who comes in mop-up situation. Outstanding member of the special teams. Had a rough afternoon for Coach Larry Smith, but jubilation on the sideline for Coach Lou Holtz. On second down, here's the quick toss to the near side, looking for some running room. Guess who they've got running the ball? Corny Southall, the defensive back, gets up to the 15-yard line. And that is going to be the last play of the game. And the Irish have upset favored Southern Cal, who came into the game a 4.5-point choice of the odds makers. And everybody, all the experts, picked to win this afternoon. The final was Notre Dame 27 and Southern California 10. Now this for State Farm.
Here's why a busy woman appreciates the State Farm Family Insurance Checkup. The job, the kids, the shopping, the meetings, the budget, the household. Women have a lot to keep up with. That's why a busy woman feels better with a State Farm agent to help her keep up with her changing insurance needs. And with State Farm's Family Insurance Checkup, there's no obligation. The advice is free, and the decisions are yours.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm.
American Honda Motor Company received a letter about a Honda Civic wagon that answers to the call. Oh, taxi!
Dear sir, in Newton, Kansas, population of 17,000 or so, there are many retired people, but no public transportation. So, a few years ago, I bought the OT Cab Company in a Civic wagon. Since most of my customers are seniors, first I thought it'd be too hard for them to get in and out of. Was I wrong? They found it had plenty of room inside, and big door openings for easy access. Now they specially request the Honda from the dispatcher. Honda has improved my service and given an all-new image to OT Cab. Best regards, Garth Mott. Oh, by the way, OT is for on time.
Honda, first in import car owner loyalty for the last 11 years.
This one will go down in the book of great wins in Notre Dame history. The Irish came to the West Coast, a 4.5-point underdog against a team that inexorably had been gaining on Notre Dame the last 3 or 4 weeks in the battle to take over the top spot in the rankings. A look at the ball action coming up on Westwood One's radio networks on Mutual. The Eagle Aloha Bowl, Christmas Day, SeaWorld Holiday Bowl, the All-America Bowl, USF&G Sugar Bowl on the NBC radio network. It'll be the Liberty Bowl, the Fiesta Bowl, the Rose Bowl, the Orange Bowl. No question, the best bowl lineup is on Westwood One radio networks.